at the IFFI Goa along with MoMA New York. ऐसा भी होता है.
They keep taking films to show what's
and
happening.
Yeah. So the Oi Lucky was premiered at MoMA New York. It also won the National Film Award for the best popular film. His next film was the experimental cult Love, Sex or Dhoka, made in 2010. So Dibakar directed India's first feature film entirely shot on digital cameras with subjects such as honor killing, MMS scandals, sting operations, etc. And its presentation made it one of the most important films of our times and the history of Indian Hindi cinema. We've seen part two of LSD, so we know, and we've spoken at length about it, we'll talk more about it. The film was followed by Shanghai and many other films like...
Thank you.
Something is Binky Farhad.
Sandeep or Binky Farhad, Detective Byomkesh Bakshi.
Detective Byomkesh Bakshi. We've seen LSD 2. We've also been privileged to see Thies. And I think I should stop here and leave it to you.
Haan, khatam ho gayi. Aur nahi banayi, abhi bana raha hoon.
Thank you so much.
So over to you, sir. आप बताएं अपने बारे में.
हाय, अपने बारे में कुछ है नहीं वैसे. आई मीन इट्स दिल्ली एंड वांटेड टू मेक फिल्म्स एंड आई थिंक एड फिल्म्स एंड ऑल दैट एंड आई थिंक देयर वाज अ सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस बिटवीन व्हेन वी ग्रू अप इन द 90s और रादर नॉट ग्रू अप लाइक वी वर वर्किंग ऑन आवर फर्स्ट जॉब्स इन द 90s एंड अभी के टाइम में थोड़ा फर्क है. I mean, I think we had much more open, anything can happen kind of an environment when we were growing up. So I guess that's why whatever happened, happened, you know. You guys gonna have it tougher. आप लोगों को वो मतलब जो हमको जो मिला है वो नहीं मिल रहा है पूरा पूरा. So, yeah, you need to figure out where's your head at. It's like you're figuring shit out and then when you're figuring shit out and you can't ask questions to figure shit out, that's the time that we did not have. We could ask. Questions were okay. Right now, questions are not okay. So that's one small problem that you guys will have to face. So you'll have to be smarter than we were, you know. I also want to know, how does a design institute look at films? Because it's connected to my memories of getting into a design institute because it had a film course in third year, fourth year. So in 2 years, my patience left. So it didn't happen to me. So I don't know how a design school, you know, works with film as narrative or film as design or as, you know, whatever. So that'll be an exciting discussion for you guys to share with me.
I can tell you as a design school, the way we are teaching film in this filmmaking project is by showing LSD 2.
Yeah.
Showing Ghode Ko Jalebi.
Yeah.
And showing Superman of Malegaon.
Yeah.
And showing Thies.
Yeah.
So these are the kind of films that we have seen.
Yeah.
And
we
are stressing on the idea that this is not a film school, this is a design school.
Yeah.
And the approach to filmmaking is a design approach to filmmaking.
Yeah.
So, and I think all LSD 2 and even Thies are very designed that way in terms of mediums and methods.
Had to be designed. So for example, in LSD 2, we had to design a game. We had to design a metaverse. We had to design a game show and its signage and its, you know, whatever. We had to, everything had to be thought up from scratch because we had to make fictitious things. And we had to pretend as different kind of designers. For example, a gaming guy will design in a certain way, but a designer who designed the set of a reality show, he comes from a different mindset. His bosses and his clients are different. Their needs are different. Then somebody who designs a metaverse and the characters, their needs are different. Then, if you remember LSD 2, in the end, one of the protagonists just leaves the physical world. And decides to exist safely in the virtual world. So he's literally redesigned himself. So that guy that you saw, that Andrew Guinness guy, pata nahi chal raha hai, ladka hai, ladki hai, kidhar hai, kya hai, you know, it's all together. So that was also a nice piece of design that we had to go through. So
that's, but the whole film as by large is a designed piece of narrative, would you call that?
Okay, so narrative has design.
Yeah.
Storytelling has design. I would say that Ek Vakt Ki Baat Thi, Ek Raja Tha is like the first car shape that you will do if the instructor says ki yaar mere ko ek car design ka ek basic exploration karke de ya ek tail light ka ek basic exploration karke de and all that. So it always starts with that first thing. So storytelling has design.
Correct.
Storytelling has design, but there the design is not in physical shapes or in colors or ergonomics or something like that. It has a design of the flow of thought.
Right.
And therefore, how do you grasp somebody's thought by giving a narrative which is, you know, graspable, you know? So, I mean, if you're designing something which is like graspable, through a hand gesture, just take that analogy to storytelling and you'll have to design something which is about, you know, story and thinking and time and, you know.
Correct. So before you guys ask your questions, please be ready with your questions. I just want to ask one very basic question. Did you always know that you wanted to be a filmmaker, and why did you want to be a filmmaker?
From about class 8th or 9th, I started seriously thinking about not being able to do anything except filmmaking. I mean, I could be an illustrator. I'm a good illustrator, so I could sort of earn a living as an illustrator. But I also wanted to tell stories. I also wanted to do storyboards. I also wanted to sketch. I also wanted to record. I also wanted to write songs or put something. So it was almost like, you know, there's a story, there's an audio to it, there is a visual aspect to it. So it automatically went there. And of course, my dad bought a television in 1975. We were one of the first, I was like four. We were like the first families in our neighborhood in Karol Bagh who had a, you know, TV, one of the first few, you know. So I was glued to the TV all the time and I used to watch a lot of films. And Doordarshan had a lot of films those days. And they were films from all over. They were films from Europe, France, Germany, anywhere. I mean, I saw some world classics, you know, sitting in front of my black and white TV in 80, 81, whatever. So films were, I was like deeply into films. Somewhere, I think around 9th or 10th, I kind of, my friends, they still tell me ke, तू बताया करता था कि मैं फिल्म बनाऊंगा हंसते थे पागल हो गया बंगाली तू यू नो सो दैट्स हाउ इट हैपेंड बट आई डोंट नो वेरी कॉन्शियसली हाउ इट वर्कड आउट व्हाट हैपेंड वाज दैट व्हेन आई वाज इन 12th तो वही माँ बाप के चक्कर में IIT और रुड़की पिलानी वो सब जो होता है वो सब किया तो IIT में अपियर करके मैं फिर मतलब काउंसलिंग में नहीं गया तो काउंसलिंग का चिट्ठी आई थी कि ए आया तो मेरी माँ बहुत खुश हो गई कि बेटे को ए मिला है तो मेरे पिताजी ने कहा कि नहीं ये एब्सेंट है तब तक आई वॉज वॉन्टिंग टू ज्वाइन FTII बट क्या हुआ कि आई फाउंड आउट इन एट 12th क्लास कि मेरे को 3 साल ग्रेजुएशन करनी पड़ेगी सो मेरी फट गई मेरे कहा मेरे ग्रेजुएशन तो मेरे से नहीं होने वाला क्योंकि वो 3 साल यू नो मेरे जो ग्रेड्स थे मतलब खालसा कॉलेज वहाँ पे जाके मतलब मेरी धुलाई होती है वहाँ पे तो मैंने कहा मेरे से नहीं झेला जाएगा मेरे ग्रेड्स अच्छे नहीं थे 65-70 के अंदर ही थे ऊपर नहीं थे ज़्यादा तो मैंने कहा कि चलो ठीक है कुछ और कुछ देख लेते हैं आर्किटेक्चर देख लेते हैं ऑल स्कूल लीवर्स प्रोग्राम्स आर्किटेक्चर NID तो NID पहले आ गया It sort of, I think it still has one of the earliest
entrance exams.
Entrance tests.
Yeah.
So I got through. Huh. And by the time all those IIT love letters came, I had already gotten through. So I was, you know, I mean, I was on my way to Ahmedabad. So that worked out. And NID I went because somewhere there was an animation and design filmmaking course, yes. Somewhere in the third year or the fourth year. In fact, I was just speaking to Anando Datta. We met in Pune. So I went and met him because he was a graphic designer and he was like heading a publication here. So he told me, it's a nice place, you'll learn. And he said, don't think of design, film, just go to the institute, go to the resource center, just have fun, you know. So I went and it turned out to be good advice actually.
And then how does this lead to Khosla Ka Ghosla then?
Khosla Ka Ghosla, I came back from, when I got chucked out, mainly because I had lots of incompletes and a lot of experiment with certain kind of plants, and that's all that happened. And but I was, you know, really, my world exploded. I'm sure you guys have a fantastic resource center, but I'm talking about 90. At that time, the resource center that NID had, the books, the magazines, racks and racks of microfilms, cassettes, tapes, the resource center blew my mind.
Yeah, it is.
So my world opened up there. Art, design, history, culture, everything was there. So I was anyway a bookworm to some. So I was, the resource center opened, you know, my world up. Then the seniors, there would be some senior who would be staying in NID for 8 years, 9 years. Uska abhi tak diploma nahi hua hai, woh baitha hua hai wahan pe. He and his partner, pressure cooker hai, woh jaake khana banate hai. So वो सब देख के आके खुद मतलब you know wow this is also way to live you know and they would tell you about music and some amazing musicians, amazing talented guys, illustrators, sketch artists, and they would talk about stuff that they would know about from design and all that. And I met for the first time people from all over India, you know. That was my first pan India experience, you know. And I used to take kids from all over the world. So I'm all over the country. So I would meet somebody from Raurkela, meet somebody from Chennai, somebody from somewhere. And it was boom, you know. So that really sort of, you know, changed me. Then there was, of course, the film club.
Yes.
So I used to be a part of the film club every summer, every chutti. We would get into the general compartment of Sabarmati or Sarvodaya Express and come to Delhi, then go to Hungarian embassy, Russian embassy, ye wo wahan se wo filmon ke dabbe hote the, wo leke jaate the. I'm sounding like an uncle now, but it was quite exciting. We would sort of, you know, see those films, go back to the, you know, NID auditorium, fantastic auditorium. I saw Raging Bull on a 35mm print. I saw, you know, so many amazing films on print.
Yeah.
I mean, actual projected. And I think I've seen a cut of Raging Bull that is still not available on DVD.
Okay.
It had some extra scenes and all that. So it was mind-blowing.
Yeah, yeah.
So that happened. But obviously, when I was doing that, I was not studying in class. Mm. So
the incompletes.
So absolutely all courses incompletes. I think I barely finished one typography course. So then they asked me to repeat a semester. I repeated a semester. Same thing happened. Then they asked me to repeat another semester. Maine kaha yaar mujhse na hoga. Abhi chalte. Then I came to Delhi and I was out of work for 7-8 months. My parents started giving me application forms of Pooja Public College, you know. Dasvi fail, barvi paso, barvi fail, graduation kare. Abhi bhi hai? So all of that, they were very worried. But 7-8 महीने में I got a trainee का job in a company which used to make corporate films.
Okay.
Not only corporate films, but there's something that you guys actually, it's from the Stone Age, which is corporate AVs. Corporate AVs would be, we would be using slides, still slides, and we'd be putting them on the carousel projectors, and each slide would be going. So it's like a slide presentation. And then came the epitome of high tech. Somewhere around 92, they discovered how to run 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 decks together. Computerized. तो वो तो मतलब height हो गई थी tech की. मतलब वो computerized 4 or 5 projectors are synchronized. You know, projecting still slides. And there were usually corporate films about India, the great defense manufacturing industry, या Pashupati Acrylon Finance. ये इस तरह के शो होते तो
same guy's voice.
प्रताप शर्मा.
प्रताप शर्मा.
So in the beginning there was a dream. बोल के चालू होता था. फिर share market. So वो सब होता था. Then from there I started. Making some films, ad films, that my boss, he also used to make some ad films. Then I started going to Bombay and, being there on shoots, loved it. And then I joined an advertising agency as a copywriter.
Okay.
I got some invaluable advice from my first boss. He said that, look, Dibs, you sketch and you write. So whenever somebody's asking you, what do you do? If you're sketching, say, I'm a writer. And if you're boarding, say I'm a writer. And if you're writing, say I'm a visualizer. So that'll keep them guessing. So I used to do that. So I joined an agency, Greater Kailash mein. And then agency life took me into this thing. Then I came under the wing of Pradeep Sarkar. In the 90s, Pradeep Sarkar was this great force in Delhi who was actually changing filmmaking, ad filmmaking and corporate filmmaking, because he was just an addict. He just passed away about a year back.
Yeah.
And he was making ad films and he was in an agency. So I had written a film as a copywriter. I went to him, ke Pradeep da, please bana do. He made it. Then he liked me. He said, come over, join me. Then I went and joined the agency that he worked in under him. And then for 2 years, Shantanu Moitra, the music director, Pradeep Sarkar, then apna Jaideep Sani, the writer of Ghosla Ka Ghosla, Company and all these films. So we were all this crazy gang who was continuously making films. I'm talking about 95-96. Then what happened was that simultaneously my NID friends, after finishing their diplomas, came. One was Amitabh Roy. He's no more, but very talented guy. So he and Indrajit Natoji, these two guys, they finished their visual communication course and they came to Delhi. And they started working with 90s again was historically a very interesting period where for the first time, you had lots of new television channels sprouting up in Delhi. And Delhi was, there were a lot of channels of news and all that. So. And there was this channel called BITV, Business India Television. And they somehow, because of the people who they had taken, wo sare choti wale the, So very, a very nice left of center kind of a feel, very freeing feel. They had a promo department. And Amitabh and Nuts joined them as promo editors. And then they brought me in as a freelance writer. And then we started making lots of those channel promos and channel idents, which in the 80s in Europe was the first time that video design came off birth. It's because of MTV, it's because of the channel idents and all those things that you saw such amazing video art in the 80s. And maybe you could do a small, course about that. At the beginning of video art in the 80s was fantastic. So in the 90s, mid 90s in Delhi, we were kind of doing a small version of that. So that happened. And before we knew it, we had a pretty nice showreel. And we were just freelancing for this channel, which supported a lot of, crazy kids like us.
Yes.
There were many other, I'm sure your faculty somewhere, somebody would have worked in BITV.
I have.
So
from there we had this thing and Shori, and then one of our friends, she used to work as a in one of the channels. She said, look, there is this another channel called Home TV which is looking for promo makers. You got a good reel. There's this guy from their UK partner who was kind of scouting around, just go. So I was working in an agency. I was like a, I don't know what I was. I think I was a creative supervisor or something on my way to be being ACD or something like that. And from there, we just got a tape and we showed him the reel and he said, okay, join us. So me, Amitabh and Nuts, we talked about it. They said, yaar, naukri to nahi karni. So he said, okay, form a company and, you know, just keep doing our promos, you know. That's how we started. It was as bizarre or not bizarre, it was as simple as that. I don't know whether things are that simple now. Could be. But in those days, since nobody knew what was happening and what could happen, everybody was trying out new things. So, and people were not suspicious of young people that much, let us say, you know. So then we started working with them for 2 years we started doing this. While this was happening, Amitabh ka ek dost tha, wo Delhi ke ek Lala company mein kaam karta tha, usne kaha Bengali aur ad film banani hai, tere saath hi banayenge. To phir humne unke liye ek ad film banayi, JVG washing machine. So wo ad thodi si hit ho gayi. तो फिर दूसरी एजेंसीज स्टार्टेड सेंडिंग अ स्मॉल स्मॉल प्रोमोज. यू नो वो कहते हैं ना कि ब्रू कॉफी के साथ पाइए एक प्लास्टिक का डब्बा फ्री. तो उस तरह के प्रोमोज बनाने चालू किए धीरे धीरे. तो वहां से देन ग्रेजुअली वी स्टार्टेड स्काउटिंग अराउंड एंड एजेंसी स्टार्टेड टू गेट टू नो अस अ लिटिल बेटर. And at that time, Pradeep was making his own ad films with his own company, Pradeep. So we started a small, you know, company. We started making ad films and it happened. And we started making money. South Delhi mein kiraye pe ghar var le liya, wo sab kar liya.
To, lots of money.
Haan. To, matlab, lots of money, matlab, humko lagta tha bahut paisa hai. So, तो सब हो गए. सबके अपने अपने गर्लफ्रेंड भी थे. हो गया, ये हो गया, सेटल हो गए, शादी वादी या नई शादी, पार्टनर वार्टनर जो भी, सब कुछ करके मतलब 27-28 साल की उम्र में अच्छा चल रहा था. और व्हाट हैपेंड वाज दैट 3-4 years, 5 years वेंट बाय व्हेन वी वर मेकिंग दीज एड फिल्म्स एंड यू नो सडनली एंजॉयिंग द एलीट साउथ दिल्ली लाइफ एंड मनी एंड व्हाटएवर एंड ऑल दैट. एंड देन आई रियलाइज दैट वो जो मैं हर वक्त पार्टी में जाके लोगों को इम्प्रेस करने के लिए बोलता था ना कि मैं फिल्म बनाना चाह रहा हूँ, वो तो हो नहीं रहा है. तो वो तो पैसे ही बन रहे हैं, फिल्म नहीं बन रही है. देन व्हाट हैपेंड वाज दैट एन एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी इन दिल्ली, नॉट वेरी फार फ्रॉम हियर, नेहरू प्लेस, द ओनर ऑफ दैट, शी न्यू जयदीप एंड जयदीप वॉज राइटिंग एंड जयदीप हैड लेफ्ट हिज एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी जॉब. And he had gone to Bombay and he was struggling as a writer. He was writing scripts for Ram Gopal Varma. He was writing scripts like Jungle, Shangal and all that. I don't know whether you've seen those films. You know, he was writing films in those days. And she called up Jaydeep and said, ki mereko yaar ek Dilli ki film banani hai, Dilli ke logon ke saath, Dilli wale scene, Dilli wala ek jo scene chahiye. To Jaydeep said ke yaar ek banda hai, wo pagal sa hai, wo baat karta rehta film banane ki, but I trust him. देख लो. सो देन वी मेट एंड देन खोसला का घोसला सार. दिस वॉज इन 2002. बाय द टाइम द फिल्म केम आउट, मेरा एड फिल्म का बिजनेस खत्म हो गया था. पैसे नहीं थे, कुछ नहीं था. आई वॉज लिटरली लिविंग ऑन माई वाइफ्स अर्निंग एंड इट टुक 4 years फॉर द फिल्म टू कम आउट. सो दैट्स हाउ खोसला घोसला केम आउट.
एंड देन दैट वॉज इनकरेजिंग इनफ फॉर यू टू कैरी ऑन इन दैट स्पेस.
सी व्हाट हैड हैपेंड वाज दैट खोसला वाज ऑलमोस्ट नॉट गेटिंग रिलीज्ड. I mean, this is not the first time. I mean, मेरे साथ ये हो चुका, मेरे साथ ये होता ही रहता है. तो मैं अभी मतलब घिस गया हूँ और मेरे को कोई मतलब कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती. कुछ भी हो जाए, यू नो, इट डजंट फेस. आई ऑफ कोर्स वेंट थ्रू डिप्रेशन एंड सॉलिड, यू नो, दिस थिंग. दैट वॉज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई सॉ थेरेपिस्ट. सो वो सब हुआ. उसके बाद क्या हुआ कि एक टाइम आया जब वी I kind of made peace with the fact that yaar ye to release nahi hone wali. जैसे ही आई मेड पीस विद द फैक्ट आई सॉ अदर प्रोड्यूसर्स, क्योंकि बॉम्बे में सारे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स और प्रोड्यूसर्स ने देख ली थी फिल्म, हमने इतनी स्क्रीनिंग्स की थी कि सबको पता था कि एक फिल्म है जो कोई नहीं खरीद रहा है, जो सब देख रहे हैं, बड़ी अच्छी फिल्म है, बड़ी अच्छी फिल्म है, कोई नहीं खरीद रहा है. सो दे स्टार्टेड गिविंग मी ऑफर्स के यार कुछ यू नो 50 लाख में एक फिल्म बना लो, 1 करोड़ में एक फिल्म बना लो. तो मैंने कहा चलो मे बी माई सेकेंड फिल्म विल बी माई फर्स्ट फिल्म. तो द मोमेंट आई स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन माई सेकेंड फिल्म UTV picked up Khosla and it got released. So that was quite interesting that the moment I left the ghost and went on to वेट चल तू नहीं तो कोई और से, you know, like that. So suddenly that clicked. So that I've never forgotten.
And was the second one also Oye Lucky?
Second one was Oye Lucky. No, no. At that point, I was researching Oye Lucky. But this film that I was trying to make, which, you know, I don't even remember what it was. It was just a hustle. I was just trying to make a film. That's all.
Please. You know, your films have a very clear point of view. And they have something to say. There is a subtext to whatever film you're making, whether it's a comment on Delhi or the politics of middle class or whatever it is. Your first film, as you said, took a while to get released. This last one is not released. Yet you don't, I feel at least, you don't compromise on what you want to make. How is that then? How do you, like after say this one,
basically I got through the cracks and somehow survived. Okay? But it'll get worse now for some time before it gets better. At least that's what I feel.
When you're saying worse, you mean expressing what you want to
expressing
say?
So I really had a lot of love for these when I made it, and when I slowly got to know from Netflix that they were saying that maybe this is not the right time to release it, I knew what they meant. So I think now after like, you know, 18 years I'm used to it. So it's like agar film nahi bana paaye to graphic novel likh lenge, you know, it's like that. So one will have to balance. And the second thing is that you have to go cheaper and cheaper so that you fall through the cracks and survive. But some stories can't be told for less money. So some stories cannot be told or may not be told for some time to come, and by the time it's safe to make them again, maybe, you know, your inner fire is not there. So it's a complex everyday kind of a weaving in and weaving out ke isko graphic novel banao, isko likhte raho, idhar aise karo. So you hustle and you survive on a tightrope. There's nothing more to it basically.
So last year when we were doing film project, we had a discussion among us that how important it is for an artist to be politically very aware. And we were discussing about it, and today you're saying that it is going to be difficult for us to express ourselves in the way we want to express. There is no solution to that we can make our, I wouldn't say political statement, but we can make our political expression still exist in the story, but in the subtext, but not really very upfront, and people who understand might understand that.
I think the best stories are that only. Stories are at a very pure level, or rather at a visceral level. Stories are heard by human beings, this is what I really feel, to make sense of their reality. If there are no stories, you will not be able to make sense of reality. It's as simple as that. I mean, I don't know how I mean, without stories, there is, we can't live without stories, you know. Your name, the clothes that you're wearing, the hair that you have, that you're sporting, the ornamentation that you wear, the way you speak, the what you like, what you don't like, what you're quiet about, what you're vocal about, is connected to a story. It has no real physical reality. It's a concept. It's a time narrative in your head. It's like, let's say you want to say ki yaar garibon ko khana nahi mil raha hai. I'm saying that's a story. Haan, hai garib jinko khana nahi mil raha hai. Lekin aap jo likh rahe ho wo to उसको अपने दिमाग में बिठा के, आप तो भूखे नहीं हो ना, आप अपने दिमाग में बिठा के उसके बारे में कुछ लिख रहे हो लेट अस से, तो वो कहानी ही है. तो हम कहानी के थ्रू अपनी लिविंग का सेंस बनाते हैं. और ये थोड़ी सी अजीब बात लग रही है लेकिन समझ जाओगे आप कि कहानी के बिना कुछ, नाम ही कहानी है यार. व्हाट्स योर नेम?
दया.
योर पेरेंट्स केप्ट इट. They had an emotion connected to it, correct? And they said, KR, I feel that this boy should be named Daya. Because I honor the emotions of Daya, Karuna, being together, whatever, 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 okay? And I am hoping that this kid will be like something. Puri kahani hai. It's pure fantasy. You may not be generous at all. I'm just saying. So it's, your name is a story from somebody else. Somebody else has made sense of you by giving a name to you, which is connected to a story. That story is the value of, more than often, if you're kind, ulta humko hi thappad padta hai. लेकिन फिर भी हमारे दिमाग में एक चीज है कि नहीं यार, काइंड रहो, अच्छा होगा, कुछ दुनिया का भला होगा. It's a story. So therefore, everything that I'm doing through my film, or any filmmaker is doing through his film, is basically keeping a story alive. Now, if that story doesn't work, nothing else will work. So you'll have to work that story out in a way. And because we are human beings, there are certain ways that we connect to stories. Wo hamari biology ke saath mixed hai. जैसे मैं अगर तुमको 8 घंटे की फिल्म दिखाऊं तो तुम पागल हो जाओगे, लेकिन 2 घंटे की फिल्म दिखाऊं तो ले लोगे. दैट मीन्स हमारे ब्रेन की बायोलॉजी के साथ कुछ संबंध है हमारा, गानी का या कुछ का. मैं अगर आपको आज कल परसों तरसों में 2 घंटा 2 घंटा 2 घंटा करके सीरियल दिखाओगे, आप देख लोगे. दैट्स द वे यू रिएक्ट टू अ स्टोरी. सो अनलेस एंड अंटिल द स्टोरी वर्क्स, नथिंग विल वर्क. सो पॉलिटिकल अवेयरनेस is another story. Kya, what is politics? What is awareness? Where do your emotions lie? Where does your support lie? What are you against? What are you for? Is the story which you have to figure out completely and then bring it down to a story that he can enjoy. He doesn't have your politics, but he has a father like you. So let us say I'll make a story about your father or somebody like your father. That's the connect. Correct? Being a father is also a story. Pitaji ki puja karo, pitaji jo bol rahe wo karo, ya pitaji ke saath rebellion karo, ya rock music karo, jo bhi karo, wo bhi kahani hai na. So it's come through our social thing. So is, you have to see what your politics is completely. Then tell a story that he can understand, even if he does not have your politics. I think that's what all of us are looking for. All of us. Kuch film hoti na arty hoti, correct? Uska matlab ye hota hai ki wo banda ye soch raha hai ki meri jo politics hai, iski bhi wohi politics hai. Main jo bol raha hu, wo ye samajh jayega. लेकिन आप नहीं समझोगे तो आपको लगे यार ये क्या है, आरटी है यार, थोड़ा ऊपर चला गया. सो दैट मैचिंग इज द थिंग दैट यू विल नीड. मैंने ज्यादा कॉम्प्लेक्स बोला लेकिन क्योंकि ये कॉम्प्लेक्स आंसर है इसलिए मैंने कोशिश की बोलने की. आई होप आई डिडंट पुट यू गाइस टू स्लीप. Same DOP for LSD2. Ooh. I saw Gabbar and got him to shoot LSD2.
And Ajay Mishra made a film on Darbhanga. I come from Darbhanga. And somebody told me.
And it's about actors.
Yes, yes. And somebody told me that there is this film, the filmmaker has made this film on Darbhanga, and Darbhanga is not very aesthetically pleasing. No one can make a film on that. Aesthetically pleasing, I mean, how?
हाँ तो उसके एस्थेटिक्स ये हैं कि जो बोल रहा है कि दरभंगा इज नॉट एस्थेटिकली प्लीजिंग उसके दिमाग में एस्थेटिक्स की एक स्टोरी है कि एस्थेटिक्स का मतलब होता है ये चाहे वो कुछ भी हो चाहे वो संजय लीला भंसाली का सेट हो या आई डोंट नो किसी अमेरिकन फिल्म का सेट हो या कुछ और वो बोल रहा है उसको एस्थेटिक है क्योंकि उसके दिमाग में एक वैल्यू सिस्टम है वो ये नहीं और वो क्या बोल रहा है कि मुझे जो अच्छा लग रहा है वो एस्थेटिक है और जो मुझे अच्छा नहीं लग रहा वो एस्थेटिक ही नहीं है. वो ये नहीं बोल रहा है कि ये अलग एस्थेटिक है. तो इस तरह दर्शक ऐसे ही होते हैं. हम ऐसे ही होते हैं. सोसाइटी इज लाइक दिस. वी एस्क्राइब वैल्यू टू थिंग्स विच डू नॉट हैव वैल्यू.
एंड माय क्वेश्चन वाज दैट आई सॉ दैट फिल्म एंड बाय द एंड ऑफ द फिल्म आई फेल्ट लाइक होम.
Because you're from Darbhanga, yes. But you have to ask who's absolutely not from Darbhanga, like big time not from Darbhanga, like but they are from a, they could be from a smaller town or something like that. Delhi ke टॉप हिप कॉलोनी से एक इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग अगर कोई लड़की हो जो मतलब कंप्लीट ऑपोजिट दरभंगा जो हो उसको दिखानी पड़ेगी. उसको दिखाओ एंड दैट पर्सन हैज टू सॉर्ट ऑफ स्पीक द ट्रूथ कि भैया मेरे को अच्छी लगी या बुरी लगी या मीडियम लगी या व्हाटएवर देन यू विल नो द आंसर.
माय क्वेश्चन हाउ टू फाइंड द ट्रूथ आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड
व्हाट इज दिस ट्रूथ
व्हाट इज दैट दैट यू स्पीक योर ट्रूथ व्हाट इज द ट्रूथ
दैट ओनली यू कैन आंसर.
हाउ डू यू अचीव दैट What do you do for that?
See, one thing I can tell you to encourage you that society from time immemorial has employed actors to speak out the truths that the society needs to hear, tough truths, to keep their balance so that they don't go insane. And insanity is not repeating the truths again and again. Insanity is suppressing the truths so that nobody is talking about the elephant in the room. That's insanity. So us insanity se bachne ke liye society, actor, theater, not film, theater, fireside theater, public theater, community theater, ye sab pehle se 4-10,000 saal se chal raha hai, theek hai? So there you will find it. There you will find it. But whether you can translate into cinema or films in the context of India and Bollywood today, that's another story. But as a street theater actor, as a stage actor, as a community actor, community theater actor, paise nahi hai, lekin truth milega. Wo ho sakta hai kuch. Or, I mean, and Delhi has that tradition over the last 40-50 years. Ke wahan pe street theater, corner theater, ye sab hota rehta hai. Abhi kya scene hai, pata nahi. अभी क्या सीन है, आप कितना बोल सकते हो कितना नहीं बोल सकते हो पता नहीं. राइट नाउ योर ट्रूथ यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट. आई मीन लाइक माय ट्रूथ इज दैट राइट नाउ माय ट्रूथ इज विच कीप्स कमिंग अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन इन माय हेड इज दैट वी आर जस्ट डिवाइडिंग पीपल एंड वी आर जस्ट डिवाइडिंग फाइंडिंग वेरियस वेज ऑफ डिवाइडिंग पीपल एंड वन ऑफ देम इज कैपिटलिज्म. I'm just saying, I mean, I'm not saying Hindu-Musliman. हिंदू मुसलमान तो है ही, लेकिन वन ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट डिवाइड्स पीपल इज कैपिटलिज्म. सो वो मेरा ट्रूथ है. सो आई एम ट्राइंग टू, यू नो, इन LSD 2 आई एम ट्राइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दैट इन सम वेज, समहाउ. बहुत हिडन सा, पता नहीं क्या है क्या नहीं है, आई डोंट नो. इन दीस आई एम ट्राइंग टू टॉक अबाउट हाउ वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिवाइड पीपल थ्रू कम्युनिटीज इन अ वे दैट दे आर कंप्लीटली कंफ्यूज अबाउट, बिकॉज देयर ट्रूथ इज दैट देयर आइडेंटिटीज आर फ्लूइड. मैं सुबह मुसलमान हूँ, शाम को लड़की हूँ, रात को सिंगर हूँ, अगले दिन मॉर्निंग AIR की अनाउंसर हूँ, दोपहर में हाउसवाइफ हूँ और 4 बजे मदर हूँ. इतनी सारी आइडेंटिटीज है मेरी. ये भी तो ट्रूथ है ना. अगर मैं बोलूँ कि मैं सिर्फ मुसलमान हूँ या सिर्फ हाउसवाइफ हूँ, इट्स नॉट द ट्रूथ, राइट? सो सम स्टोरी हैज टू बी देयर which has to show a housewife who is an All India Radio newscaster, who is now a mother, who cooks also, and who also fell in love with somebody she can't forget. Our mother's truth is what? Our mothers also must have fallen in love with somebody who they didn't marry. You know what I'm saying? Like my mother, she fell in love with Uttam Kumar. So she keeps talking. He's an actor in Bengali cinema. She keeps talking about it. She keeps dreaming about Uttam Kumar is coming with a Varmala. You know? So it's a truth. So you have to put it in the mix. So I hope in a long-winded way I'm answering your question, because the question's correct. Did it make sense?
The question was, what is truth and how do I find my truth?
Since you said that for you that truth is about capitalism, and then I was trying to think about your overall filmography, like what it suggests. I felt it's probably most of the part of it is about class struggle.
Yeah.
And if that's like you were saying, I can recall the scene from LSD 2 where Kullu is talking to her manager. She says to do this job, I have to do other things, which she is questioning. Is that the narrative?
Yeah, I'm happy that you said that. I mean, I'm kind of happy that you said that, because but it has to come down to, that's the truth. But for Kullu, the lived experience is, and I'm going to say something graphic and rather unpleasant. For those who remember the film, and for those who haven't seen the film, Kullu is a transgender worker in a metro company who also has to moonlight as a prostitute to sort of kind of pay the rent in her house, because she is living in a place which is close to her metro station so that she can land up at 8 a.m. for her duty. But to live in that place where transgenders are not allowed, she has to pay 3 times the rent. To finance the 3 times the rent that she needs to pay to reach her job in time, which she wants desperately to hold on to, she doesn't want to lose the job, she has to prostitute herself. Now, in one of those occasions, she gets beaten up, okay? And by mistake and by the misplaced sort of, you know, samaj sudhar order of her manager, पुलिस में रिपोर्ट हो जाती है कि ये है, इसको रेप हुआ है, इसके साथ बड़ा बुरा हुआ है. अब पुलिस को पता है क्या हो रहा है. 4 दिन बाद पुलिस बोलती है कि ये तो 5 सैंपल मिले हैं. दैट्स व्हाई इन द एंड से कि वो 5 सैंपल में नहीं मिले तो आपका बाथरूम साफ नहीं होगा मैडम. सो आई थिंक द आंसर इज कि वहां पे ट्रूथ है कि यू नो मेरे बॉडी में अगर वो 5 सैंपल सीमेन के नहीं मिले तो मेट्रो का बाथरूम साफ नहीं होगा. इट हैज टू कम डाउन टू दैट, तब जाके ही विल अंडरस्टैंड और शी विल अंडरस्टैंड और व्हाटएवर, एटलीस्ट जिसका दिमाग खुला, यू नो, जो थोड़ा सुन रहा है. सो दैट्स इंपॉर्टेंट दैट दिस आई हैवंट लर्नड ओवरनाइट. मतलब लगे, काफी साल लगे मर मरा के, एंड ऑल्सो वर्किंग विद राइटर्स हु आर बेटर देन यू आर. LSD2 के राइटर से प्रतीक और शुभम, इफ यू शुड गो ऑन नेटफ्लिक्स एंड वॉच अ फिल्म कॉल ई बाले हूं, एक्चुअली यू शुड स्क्रीन इट, मजा आ जाएगा.
नई वाली भी हम दिखाने वाले थे, जल तू जला
वो आईफोन वाली आईफोन वाली मैंने नहीं देखी, हाँ मेरे को भी देखनी
है। हाँ हाँ हाँ
हाँ तो अब प्रतीक और शुभम, और प्रतीक एफटीआई का बंदा है, उसने जब एफटीआई में वो चेयरमैन का झमेला हुआ था, जब वो अवार्ड वापसी वगैरह हुई थी, तो उसने वोकल प्रोटेस्ट किया था, फिर उसके खिलाफ पुलिस के केस हैं। तो प्रतीक का ट्रूथ ये है कि वो सुबह समझ लो स्क्रिप्ट लिख रहा है या जूम कर रहा है या कान में किसी प्रोड्यूसर से बात कर रहा है, 4 बजे उसको पुणे थाने में जाना है रिपोर्ट करने कि मैं पुणे में हूं या ये, तो ये उसकी ट्रूथ है, तो वहां पे आनी चाहिए चीज। सो इट टुक मी सम टाइम टू वर्क विद राइटर्स लाइक दीज, गौरव सोलंकी हु रोट दीज इज एक्चुअली अ यंग ज्ञानपीठ अवार्ड विनर। आप में से जो लोग हिंदी पढ़ सकते हो जरूर पढ़ना 11वीं के लड़के, 11वीं के लड़के उसकी एक स्टोरीज की एंथोलॉजी है। चक्कर ये है कि प्रॉब्लम इज दैट अ यू नो देयर्स मच बेटर वर्क हैपनिंग इन वर्नाक्युलर लैंग्वेजेस देन इन इंग्लिश। इंग्लिश यू आर गेटिंग शाइट, एब्सोल्यूट शाइट। क्रॉसवर्ड बेस्ट सेलर्स पढ़ोगे वही होता रहेगा। कुछ कुछ चीजें होती हैं, जैसे रेत समाधि है, उसका इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन निकल गया, मोटी बुक है, लेकिन आई एम नॉट सेइंग स्टार्ट रीडिंग, यू कैन यू नो कीप वॉचिंग ऑल्सो, बट ऑल आई एम सेइंग इज दैट यू हैव टू कीप रीडिंग गाइज एंड गर्ल्स हु बी इन्वेस्टेड इन एग्जैक्टली योर क्वेश्चन एंड फीलिंग द ट्रूथ एंड ट्राइंग टू फाइंड अ स्टोरी विच डिपिक्ट्स दैट। रीड दिस गाय MN the Big Home, अपना जेरी पिंटो, राइट, जेरी पिंटो, रीड MN the Big Home, इट्स इन इंग्लिश, इट्स अबाउट बॉम्बे, इट्स अबाउट अ गाय एंड हिज फैमिली एंड हिज मॉम, हाँ हाँ। सो देर आर गुड एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंसेस। ओके, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर इन थेरेपी? लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंस, चलो ठीक है, लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंस एक चीज होती है, आजकल सारे बच्चे सीख गए, करेक्ट? तुम्हारा जो लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंस है वो है, उसके अंदर ट्रूथ है और कहीं नहीं। सो इन राइटर्स को पढ़ोगे तो समझ में आ जाएगा, फिल्म्स द काइंड ऑफ फिल्म्स दैट इज शोइंग समझ में आ जाएगा। मंटो तो है, लेकिन मंटो क्या है कि वो 70 साल पुराना हो गया, यू मे नॉट बी एबल टू कनेक्ट विद इट। You read, definitely read Manto, but read contemporary stuff also. Lots of stuff happening, lots of things happening. And in vernacular languages. Hindi mein toh achhai kaam ho raha hai. Hindi mein toh achhai kaam ho raha hai. Lekin woh Hindi, ab woh, ab Hindi padhna aana chahiye, woh alag baat hai.
From a purely creative standpoint, I'll give you 2 examples and then I'll give you the question. For example, in Khosla, this might be silly, but Khosla mein when Shady ka bhai, he's usko utha rahe hote hain, you know, on the couch, he has his he's mooning the screen, which might be a silly thing, but it's a nuance. I mean, that's a creative choice, I think, because you can see the ass.
No, he's not mooning. See, the thing is, I have, I was very young then, man. It was like, you know, 20 years ago. The thing is, I have grown up seeing my friends' ass cracks all my life. And in those days, the jeans and today, I've always seen these guys would wear these jeans or things. And they wouldn't know, poor guys. They would go, and the whole day I would try and look away from ass crack, hairy ass cracks. So I thought that, you know, he's a funny guy and he's sleeping and like that. So it'll be fun. Truth. Lived experience.
like Delhi, that's why it felt like home. You know, Delhi.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. It happens. It happens.
And for the second example, these. Huh. The whole movie. I'm not from their background. I don't know these characters. Hmm. But the shots themselves, the whole setting, makes me feel ki jab unke ghar pe jhagda hoga, I feel like main bhi sar pakad ke baith jaun unke ghar pe. that balance.
कौन सा वाला झगड़ा बताओ? तो एक हैं? 89 में जो झगड़ा हो रहा है, तो और जो जो दो आंटियों में जो झगड़ा हो रहा है ना,
दो आंटी में एक चप्पल वाला
झगड़ा, हाँ चप्पल पीटने वाला, करेक्ट 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 करेक्ट. तू हमारी मम्मियां करती थी ना और करती हैं. एंड सी द थिंग इज, प्रॉब्लम इज दैट योर मॉम वुड बी माय एज एंड शी वुड बी लाइक नॉट एज यू नो नॉट लाइक एग्जैक्टली लाइक दैट लेडी हु वाज लाइक in 89, that's more like my mom, you know. So we've all seen those powerful, and I'm glad that you brought this question up. I've grown up seeing moms rule, you know. I had a friend who had a, you know, very very, that friend's no more, and I just met auntie. So I've always seen auntie, I've seen my mother, I've seen other people who were like battleships. I mean, you couldn't fuck with them. They would, I mean, so, and they would run the house. But jaise hi papa aate the, mood change. Aur wo bhi mummy hi bolti thi ki papa aa gaye abhi. Aise nahi. So whatever. So all of that I tried to put in that Kashmir story, because I remember that papa aate hi na ghar mein sab chup ho jaate the. कि अभी ऑफिस से आए हैं, अभी चाय दो, कुछ दो, ये दो, वट एवर. देन थिंग्स लाइक वो बच्चा आके बोल रहा है कि मम्मी ये इसने फिर से सुसु कर दिया. दैट्स माय होम, दैट्स माय डॉटर्स. द ओल्डर वन एंड द यंगर वन, दे हैव अ 4-year डिफरेंस. द ओल्डर, पापा शी स्पीड अगेन, हु इज गोना क्लीन द बेड. सो वो इंग्लिश में बोलती है, मुझे बोल रही है. तो लेकिन वही है कि अपनी जिंदगी से डालना पड़ता है. एंड यू हैव टू इमेजिन that everybody's got the same mums, everybody's got the same fights, it doesn't change. Everybody's got the same issues. Your clothes might change, feminism might change, the power the woman has in the family or whatever it is, but a lot of things stay close to our lived experiences. So you tap on them and maybe this can happen, what you just said.
So if you go into unfamiliar territories, aisa kuch experience nahi kiya, so what is the process? Main karu wo experience, how do I show it?
Research. For these, what happened was that, see, I knew the 2019 life, but still, we actually went and had long chat sessions with a gay couple who live in Bombay. In fact, they have kids. So बहुत लंबी लंबी बात है कि then we met other gay people, because I'm not gay, so I don't know, plus I'm not a woman, so I don't know how a gay woman lives with her partner like any other partner. And if you're gay, you forget you're gay. If you're a guy, you forget you're a guy. If you're a woman, you forget you're a woman. You just yourself, the non-sexual self of you. So gay people are just people, but gay people living in a conservative society can be blackmailed by as simple a thing like cook nahi aayegi. That's the lived experience. Ab wo Bombay mein hua hai, humne research ki aur logo se, lots of middle class westernized urbanized Muslim couples, when they go to these societies, काफी उनको पापड़ बेलने पड़ते हैं. ऐसा नहीं कि कोई ऊपर से उनको बोलता है, नीचे नीचे से बहुत सी चीज, कुक नहीं आता है, या रजिस्ट्रेशन के टाइम पे बोलते हैं कि आप पार्टनर के नाम पे कर लो ना रजिस्ट्रेशन, उनका नाम तो अच्छा है, उनका नाम ठीक है. सो इट्स अबाउट योर नेम, इट्स अबाउट योर आइडेंटिटी. सो दीज थिंग्स वी फाउंड आउट. Some of it I knew. Kashmir I did not know at all, except from my readings about Kashmir, because when, so we went into a full-blooded research of Kashmir. I went there. I actually employed two documentary filmmakers from Delhi, Shabani and Samreen, who've also worked with me on a previous film, to research the whole thing. they went and interviewed some, you know, hajar people. In fact, you should call them and figure and talk about the research. Kabhi got time mile to. So they researched it for months. So usse kuch nikla, fir Kashmir gaya. Kashmir mein jaake wahan ke logon se mila jo us time jinko yaad ho, Muslim bhi ho ya Kashmiri pandit bhi ho. So that took a lot of time. Then if you looking at the future, then the whole team sat down and extrapolated today's reality into 20 years from now. So one of our things was that things don't change as much as you think they have. So in trying to make 2042, what we did was, we knew that we were in 2022. We started looking at pictures of 99, 20 years before 2022. And we saw that these things are not very different. But these things are different. For example, 1999 and 2022 mein main cheez kya hogi? Ek cheez jo nahi hogi. Smartphone. Smartphone nahi. Cell phone hai. Smartphone nahi. Actually, the laptops look the same. If I look a little from far away, laptops haven't changed. This shirt and your hairstyle would have gone completely in 1999. I mean, yeah. So all these things are very subtle changes. So what we did was, we did 2022, and this is very interesting for design students. We extrapolated 2022 with 1999 and said, okay, now see this and project it further and then change it. And it's up to you whether you want to accelerate the change or you want to retard the change. We retarded the change because what we see, the material culture around us, and this is very, 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 it applies to design hugely, is connected to everything but design. It's connected to politics, it's connected to gender, it's connected to society, it's connected to sociology, it's connected to climate, it's connected to accidents that have happened, you know, geological accidents or whatever. So, for example, one of the things is that all over the world, people are wearing lesser and thinner fabrics because it's getting warmer and warmer and warmer. So, we decided that there would be no winter. It'll just be patle kapde. And then we tried a trick where we said that, look, another thing that keeps happening is cycles keep coming back. Things keep coming back in a new way. So we kind of extrapolated that early 80s ka jo tha ek, oh, kuch ajeeb sa ek, you notice that? Yeah, so that's, we were trying that early 80s kind of thing as if it has come back for some time. Then also politically, we also kind of projected a society which was heavily controlled. And it's a military society. We didn't say it. We didn't say it. Huh?
It was on the screen in the back.
Yeah, yeah, that lady, who's, she's the head of the nation. She's a DA. So she's the head of the nation who keeps saluting all the time. Usko dekhte rehte ho. But it's a military, it's a martial law. So, but we didn't say it. But martial law will keep, will affect design in everyday way. The first thing that it affects is signage. It starts antisepticizing. It starts taking the happiness away. It starts becoming a very disciplinary force. It starts becoming a very coercive, big brother is watching kind of a force. So you go back to the Soviet era or, you know, whatever, and try and see, how does a martial law society keep signages, you know, and then those sounds, okay, you can't stay here, you have to go out and this and that. All of it is a part of, as you said, a very interesting game of looking at now and looking at back, looking at projecting a future and then researching what you need to do. So, yeah. It was fun, actually.
Language of the future.
Yeah. Very interesting thing that, you know, our slangs change, right? Like, if 10 years ago I said, dope dude, gir jayega mere pe, kya bol rahe tu, you know? So, तो हिंदी में क्यों भड़ा रहा है, यू नो, देन आई एम वेरी वेरी हैप्पी अबाउट दैट. यू मेरी याद है वो गाली जो है गणपति, तो आई रियली लव दैट गाली. वो सब एक दूसरे को, इट्स अ वेरी कॉमन गाली, वो लड़की भी लड़के को दे रही है, यू नो. इट्स लाइक अ, इट्स लाइक अ, व्हाट आर यू डूइंग, यू यू नो, यू फकर. अगर आज अगर कोई दोस्त को ऐसे बोले तो आज से 20 साल बाद वो एक वी काइंड ऑफ यू नो इन्वेंटेड अ गाली फॉर दैट टाइम एंड ऑल दैट. सो दैट वॉज क्वाइट फन. I'm a bit, okay, this is an educational institute, but this is education too. Yeah. So,
we were asking.
I wanted to ask about LST. You partly answered about the research processes, but virtually whatever you were able to do in the film, as in how do you decide in terms of film language, how much you can push, and the audience will still be able to make sense of it? Because it's all handheld and how people are using actually right now. Like it's not new to us, but as a film it's a different language that how we perceive that. So where to draw that line?
Usually it's a very foolish and a very reckless exercise. What happens is that when you start a film, यू आर इन अ स्पेस वे यू थिंक जो भी तुम कर रहे हो बहुत ही अच्छा है और सब बोलेंगे और सब देखेंगे और वाह वाह करेंगे. सो देर इज दैट फॉल्स कॉन्फिडेंस दैट यू हैव वेन यू बिगिन द फिल्म. सो दैट्स वेन वेन LSD2 स्टार्टेड. नाउ LSD2 की हिस्ट्री ये है कि पहली LSD में बिकॉज इट्स डिजिटल ये वो सब कुछ सर्वेलेंस कैमरा एंड ऑल दैट, सो वी डिसाइडेड दैट इट हैव टू टेक दैट 10 years फ्रॉम नाउ, 10 years फ्रॉम देन, एंड इट हैज टू गिव अस द visual reality of today as we represent ourselves on smartphones, social media, ye wo. So we had to start from there, and the rest was about, some of it was literally analyzing what an Insta post is. Upar kya hota hai, niche kya hota hai, kyun dalte hai, कौन अपने वो इमोजीज डालता है, कौन कैसे क्या करता है, इसके पीछे पूरी पूरी दुनिया है. तो वो पूरा जानना पड़ा. वी हैव टू लर्न दैट. एंड देन अदर थिंग्स लाइक देयर वाज समथिंग दैट आई वाज ट्राइंग एंड दिस वाज जस्ट यार LSD में मैंने वो किया था, इसमें क्या करूं LSD2 में. सो आई ट्राइड समथिंग कॉल्ड द हाइपर POV कैमरा वेयर यू आर नॉट सीइंग द कैरेक्टर बट यू आर फीलिंग द कैरेक्टर. सो आई वॉन्टेड दैट, यू नो, ओके, इन फिल्म्स very simple, if he and I are talking, there are only two ways to show it. Either I show him or I show myself. There is no, or, and there is a shot where I can show both of us. Okay? Now, I'm looking at him and he is saying something to me, and suppose the director wants to get into my emotions. The only thing in film language today that we have is, you show my shot first, looking at him, then you show his shot. That's it. Everybody from Tarantino to D.W. Griffith has only used this. There is no other way to show that I'm listening to him. Iska shot aega, fir mera shot aega, fir iska shot aega. To humne kaha ki yaar hum bahut badi cheez hai, hum kya kare, kuch naya banaye and all that. So what we did was, my POV of you is this great sort of, you know, bunch of people, and this hand which is out of focus because I'm looking at you and I'm not looking at this hand, and let's say somebody says something very embarrassing, and just to cover my embarrassment I go for the glass, and then when I drink it, you know, my eyes go there because I want to avoid his eyes. So all of this I have to catch through the camera for the audience to hopefully feel ke main iske andar ghus gaya. So we had to work out a helmet cam which was put on the actor, and everything that the actor did while acting was being shot like that. So that's how we shot those hyper POV shots. When it comes to gaming, we spoke to a gaming company, we looked at gaming, and we found a sort of, you know, exercise. There was an animation design company which did the whole look for LSD2. In fact, they are from NID also. Switch, Roy and Upasana. Roy and Upasana. So they are from NID. They did the whole design. It's, I mean, we gave them the whole contract. I mean, tomorrow, some of you could be owning a company where a filmmaker will come, okay, boss, ye film hai. Top se leke bottom tak. Credit sequence, end sequence, undercut design, the whole visualization, you have to design for me. That means you have to know the story, you have to know the shots, you have to know how the director is actually looking at the film, and then you have to design that. So that was very exciting. So that's how we did it. Again, working with people, you never do it alone. Filmmaking is teamwork. So you work with your production designer who decides the look, you work with a CGI company who's doing the gaming, you're working with a designing company which is providing the design to the CGI company, you know, like that.
His question, the game design which was there, it was a mixture of a lot of reality shows.
कौन सा वाला?
LSD2.
हाँ, end में क्या? Better was?
No. So the platform that it was creating now, it was a mixture of
reality. The reality show, right?
Yes. Huh. It was a mixture of Big Boss, Big
Yes, and yes, 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 yes.
People consume.
Yes.
How many shows you have watched, and what was the experience?
So, I watched a lot of shows. I watched a lot of shows. Watched a lot of fights on shows. Watched a lot of, you know, how the judges sort of speak. But the thing is that now as a filmmaker, not only do I have to watch how they behave, I have to watch ki ye kaun sa wala shot laga hai. Close up hai, wide hai, jo live editor hai wo kaise kaat raha hai. Agar mistake ho jaye live show mein, jaise kisi ka blank expression aa jaye, hota hai na. So वही तो दिखा था ना कि दिस इज लाइव एडिटिंग, दिस इज अ लाइव शो, दिस इज अ रियलिटी शो. सो कैसे ब्लैंक एक्सप्रेशन डालो, कैसे फट 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 काटो, कैसे, सो वो सब स्टडी करना पड़ता है. सो रियलिटी शोज हैव अ वे ऑफ कटिंग अ प्रोग्राम विच इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ देयर लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंस. कि अभी हो रहा है, स्विचर है, लाइव जा रहा है, 8 मिनट है. इन 8 मिनट्स यू हैव टू एडिट द नेक्स्ट 5 मिनट्स. यू हैव ओनली 8 मिनट्स टू डिसाइड. After that, it's like, so उस 8 मिनट में there's a floor manager, चल उसको दे, उसको दे, उसको दे, वो रो रहा है, उसको दे. तो जल्दी जल्दी में जो होता है, टक 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 टक, that is something that we have to learn. We have to speak to a reality show director to understand how it's done and what are the problems that they've, and then you kind of take that, you don't copy it. That's another thing. It's not a pastiche, it's not a spoof, it's not a send up, it's not like that. You don't copy it, you take the essence of that and then you try and tweak it according to what you want to say. So it's a bit of cheating. You take that feel, but you do your own telling. But kahan pe feel hai, kahan pe apni baat kahi ja rahi hai, kahan pe aap compromise karoge, kahan pe fuzzy hai, wo sab dekhna padta hai. No, I wanted to go back to the ad film company, but I had been out of the scene for a year, year and a half. In the ad film business, if you're out of the scene for 2 years, then by that time, you know, people have, you know, forgotten you. So it took some time to come back and get in. So I was desperately sort of, you know, wanting to, you know, get back into ad films. But fortunately, my wife was in the corporate sector. So she had a steady salary. So we survived. So that's how it happened. But I desperately wanted to get back to the ad, get back to ad films. You know, I mean, you got to pay your EMIs and, you know, whatever.
I had a question. Like, the way you tell stories is like having different narratives that go parallelly with each other and then they converge in the end of the movie to tell the whole story. How did you decide ki ye a form of storytelling mein ko aise hi karna, not like any other linear form of storytelling where the
It's a good question, but it's only applies to LSD 2 and these, because three stories together. I have a feeling that I have gotten a little bored of one story film as of now. As of now, I've gotten a little bored of one story. So what happened was LSD had three stories, which were three different stories, but they were connecting.
Yeah.
Also, I'm hugely interested in time. Which means that different times coming together. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I don't know how to say it. It's like this moment being the memory of somebody while being a future of someone else at the same time, and then weaving it in into something else. So LSD, when we were writing three different stories, it came as a sudden idea ke inko time se connect karte hain, where what you're seeing in the beginning is necessarily not the beginning. You are seeing middle, start, end, beginning. So that way you get to hear or feel something else about these people's lives. For example, LSD-1 mar jata hai, wo jo bhi hota hai. The two kids who get beheaded in the first film, there are two kids. They get beheaded because of this. In the end, you see them alive. In fact, a famous Bollywood actress who saw the film said, "Oh, thank God they're alive." So her partner said, "They are not alive." So I like that. But after that, I dropped it for a while and I went to do other things. When I was writing these, it came to me because I really wanted to tell the story of this family, this very Indian family, over 50 years. Because the story of these is nothing if you don't take the generations, our families, who we are, our grandfathers, our parents, they were young like us. They were confused and in love like us. If you don't go through that 50 year span, then fir wo kahani mein maza nahi aayega. So to go through that 50 year span, we thought of this. And LSD 2, since this was a sequel, we had to keep the three stories and all that thoda sa ek format ke hisab se. So that's how it happened. But my next film is like one story. But I think I like changing the voice within the story. Like I like reading books where the voice changes or the style changes or the time changes, within the story. So like whatever I'm writing right now, I'm trying to change the style in the middle because it's got a story connection. Ke style change karke hi story bata sakte hain.
Also, sir, about this style of storytelling, it's very easy for an audience to get confused ki story mein kya ho raha hai abhi.
Yeah.
Like, even with the conversation with the faculty, we were like, ki time lagega thoda digest karne mein story ko ki kya hua hai. How do you make sure ki aap jo point convey karna cha rahe ho wo waise hi convey ho raha hai, nobody is perceiving it in a random order?
It's complete false confidence in the beginning of the film. और लगता है कि हाँ हाँ मैं तो बहुत ही मैं तो समझ में आ जाएगा सब समझ में बहुत अच्छे जब फिल्म बन जाती है तो बेटे क्या हुआ कुछ समझ नहीं आ रही तब जाके बट आई मीन तब तक बन चुकी है डैमेज इज डन मूव ऑन सो कुछ नहीं कर सकते सो एज आई सेड इट्स जेन्युइनली अ स्टूपिड इम्पल्स वेयर यू फील दैट व्हाट यू हैव इन योर हेड विल ऑटोमेटिकली कनेक्ट एंड देन बाय द टाइम द फिल्म फिनिशेस यू रियलाइज दैट सम थिंग्स कनेक्ट सम थिंग्स टेक टाइम टू कनेक्ट and some things do not connect. And then you learn from your mistakes and move on. वो करके करना पड़ता है. पहले से नहीं पता चलता कभी भी. नहीं तो फिर आप चालू ही नहीं कर पाओगे. बेवकूफी अगर नहीं की तो फिर फिल्में नहीं बन सकती. Genuinely.
Follow-up question to that. How do you know when you're writing a story? How do you know कि अब I have I've done it. Like मेरा point across हो गया. Like it's been conveyed. And now I can end it. Because piece mein, it seemed like yeah, the it is there, but it seemed like, you know, I want more out of it, like thoda aur kuch chahiye.
I get a lot of that on my films. Frankly, I like it. In fact, Tagore, you guys know about Tagore? So Tagore said something. Again, this is very Unclish, but it's nice. He said that he talked about the perfect ending. He said it in Bong. He said ke खत्म होके भी लगा के खत्म नहीं हुआ. सो आई लाइक दैट काइंड ऑफ स्टोरी टेलिंग, सो दैट वो इट फिनिशेस एंड इट प्लेज इन योर हेड, बिकॉज दैट्स व्हेन दैट एक्स्ट्रा अमाउंट ऑफ मीनिंग मेकिंग हैपेंस, वेयर होपफुली माय ट्रूथ एंड योर ट्रूथ कनेक्ट्स. होपफुली इट डजंट हैपन ऑल द टाइम, बट एज ही सेड दैट खत्म होने के बाद अगर दिमाग में कुछ चक्कर चले, प्रोवाइडेड यू हैव टाइम, सो यू नो, सो दैट्स व्हेन इट हैपेंस. व्हाट्स प्रॉब्लमैटिक इज दैट बिकॉज ऑफ द लाइफ्स दैट वी आर लीडिंग, वी आर बीइंग एनकरेज्ड टू कंज्यूम नैरेटिव्स ऑल्सो एज इमीडिएट ग्रेटिफिकेशन. नैरेटिव्स वर नेवर मेंट फॉर इमीडिएट ग्रेटिफिकेशन. Narratives were always meant for some suno, live karo, go through the emotions and agle din us dimag mein chalta rahe. That's how the oldest Ramayan plays in India would play. It's not for nothing that Ramayan is in seven parts, because the guy would come and over 7 days he would narrate Ramayan. And on the first day, he'll leave you at a cliffhanger. Second day, something else. Second day, something. Towards the end of the narrative, he will take you to Lav and Kush and Ram. And Ram, you know, really heartbroken at what he has done to his family and to his wife when Sita decides to go back into the earth. So, and when you come out of that, you keep living the tragedy of that. I'm just giving the most universal example, let's say, in the Indian context. So that feeling I like. And in fact, I've been blamed and I've been accused of telling stories which are slightly difficult to understand or difficult to digest or whatever, or slightly over the head or something like that. I sincerely don't think so. I think they're not over the head. I think you have to be open to it. If you are closed and if you just want tak 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 khake khatam karo, wo ek alag tarike ki film hoti hai. I also watch it. I remember a friend of mine died and a common friend, we went and watched Police Academy 4 just to forget it, you know. So that also is that.
Also, some political question. So, in Peace, I really liked your representation of Kashmir. Although I am not from there or something, but it's really nice. Especially the fact that throughout the movie, especially in Aisha's age, in that time, you showing the exodus and stuff without showing the exodus, which is very interesting. And I also like the fact that throughout the movie, you're on the side of these Kashmiri pandits as well as on the side of the Muslims as well. And that one line was enough for Aisha to say, ki, haan, there was a time when my family owned the entire land. So I like
Usha. Usha says that anger comes out.
Yeah.
Very
interesting.
Who does a book, writes a book or a film or something like that, is looking for power. I'm looking for cultural power. कि भैया मैं फिल्म बनाऊंगा, सब आएंगे, सब देखेंगे, वाह वाह क्या फिल्म बनाई है, बढ़िया फिल्म है यार, तुम हमारे ये लो ये अवार्ड लो, ये लो ये अवार्ड, ये लो ये, ठीक है, ये मेरे को चाहिए. When someone wants, when a society and when a state tells its citizens that look, we are into power and this kind of power, and if you become our mouthpiece, you will get power. So therefore, a lot of us, like me, who are looking for power, start making or becoming the mouthpiece of whoever is in power. This is not new. It's just that you have to know why they are doing it. It's for power. For example, आशा पारेख का एक बड़ा अच्छा इंटरव्यू आया था, उसमें कश्मीर फाइल में पता नहीं बहुत बहुत करोड़ बनाए कश्मीर फाइल्स ने, तो कुछ बात हो रही थी, तो आशा पारेख ने बहुत अच्छी बात है आपने 50 करोड़ बनाए, दे दो कश्मीरी पंडित हो, क्यों नहीं दिया? सो दैट्स अ करेक्ट आंसर, आई मीन दैट्स अ करेक्ट क्वेश्चन रादर, बट द थिंग इज दैट हम सब पावर ढूंढते हैं. आई वुड रादर दैट वी डोंट लुक फॉर पावर बाय बिकमिंग द माउथ पीस ऑफ पावर. That's all I can say. I mean, बच्चों और मैं तुम्हें क्या बता सकता हूँ?
Do you expect a lot of backlash when you make these kind of
posts? I'm in the backlash. They never released it. They never released it. I can't even send it to any, you know, frigging festival because, you know, Netflix has got a rule that, you know, they will send a film to a festival if they have a release plan for it. Now, the film that they don't want to release can't have a release plan, so it can't even be sent to festivals. So I'm like, you know, jo jo bhi milta hai, to mere friend ne bola ki, ha ha, you will show it to the whole world, two at a time, ho jayega.
Ha, ho jayega.
10-20 saal lagenge, ho jayega. So this is it. I am actually in the backlash.
जब आपने मूवी बनाया और आपने देखा, आपको उसके बाद लगा कि this is a problem I will face and
नहीं,
नहीं लगा,
नहीं. Because as she said, it's even-handed.
Right, and even I felt my family roots being from Kashmir.
Hello.
Like, बिल्कुल ऐसा लगा कुछ shooting है या कुछ ऐसा होना.
You're a KP?
No, not.
तो?
Basically, Nanu lived near Pakistan.
Okay, no, you're Hindu or you're Muslim?
No, I'm
Hindu, but you're not a Kashmiri Pandit. You.
Not a Kashmiri Pandit. I've heard stories and they have lived closely in Jammu. So I'm.
Jammu. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I do not see a point why was this not used.
सी मुझे जो अंदर की बात पता चली है वो ये है कि आई डोंट थिंक द कश्मीर थिंग इज देयर बट इट्स द फ्यूचर थिंग दैट स्केयर्ड नेटफ्लिक्स आई हैव हर्ड दीज आर लाइक आई हैव हर्ड सो आई डोंट नो बन गई अब तो कुछ नहीं कर सकते
Like
yeah, yeah, yeah. Probably the so-called, you know, the critics keep saying, "Oh, Dibakar, you've shown a dystopian future." So I keep telling them that we who live in this time, we don't call it dystopian. But if we show this time to somebody living in 1966, we can easily put this as a dystopian future. But are we dystopic? No. We are happy. We are trying to do something. We are hopeful or whatever. So dystopia is a label that you put on it from your perspective. Those guys are just living their lives. 8:30 के बाद अगर तुम्हारे चिप में वो वाला परमिट नहीं है तो 8:30 के बाद तुम ओखला मेट्रो स्टेशन में नहीं रह सकते. So it's we can imagine it. I mean it's very imaginable. So they are not treating it as dystopia. It's our feeling कि ये लोग कहाँ पहुँच गए. I think. Maybe that's what they are. I don't know.
Ghost
movies,
जो आपका section था, I really tried to crack your vision, but I could not. So I just wanted कि मतलब, what do you think?
हो क्या रहा था?
हो क्या रहा था? अच्छा, ghost stories में लगा?
हाँ, मतलब नहीं, मुझे समझ आ गया क्या हुआ, but फिर भी I want to hear your side.
Okay. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे सेड के पहले हॉरर बनाते हैं, फिर बात हुई, फिर करण जोया देओल से कि नहीं यार हॉरर वॉरर लोग डर जाएंगे, लोग गोस्ट बनाओ. तो मैंने कहा ठीक है भूत की बनाते हैं, बट आई वॉन्टेड टू डू वॉट आई वॉन्टेड टू डू. सो माई थिंग वॉज दैट देर इज दिस गाय हु वॉज अबाउट टू एंटर अ विलेज, ही हैज अ फॉल, ही गेट्स अप एंड ही हैज अ विजन. And probably those are just ghosts. And then he wakes up and then he realizes that this village has been burnt some 30 days ago. Kuch riot hua tha. And then he gets into the car. Aur wo jo usko चारों तरफ बैठे हुए हैं वो वही वाले हैं जो उसको दिखे थे. दैट्स ऑल. आई मीन व्हाटएवर. या आई वांटेड टू डू अ ज़ॉम्बी फिल्म. दैट्स इट.
How did you come to the character design of the zombies and monsters? Because
it was
very
fun.
Unique. Very unique.
I sketched them all. It was fun. I sketched them all. Then I went to another NID team who are doing very interesting prosthetic makeup work in Ahmedabad. I've forgotten their names.
Dirty hands.
Who are the Rajiv and? His wife, Rajiv and his partner. I mean, well, there's this couple. So I did the sketches. Phir usne plaster ke sculptures banaye. He's a sculptor. Pure banaye. And we took face casts of all the actors. Jinhone wo pehna tha. Then we got a latex worker from Utah, USA, who came and who did the initial casting here in Utah, came with the suits to India, and then we tried them on, refitted them, worked them on, and then we painted them. And it was a tough one. I mean, like, for example, Gulshan's suit had two versions because there was that scene na jab wo uchhal ke wo apni beti ko khata hai. That's a Paco artist. Because he can jump like that from the table, he jumped like 15 feet to where you are. You know, literally from here, one jump. Because he's trained to do that. But Gulshan can't do that. So we had to do two suits, one for him, one for them, whatever. So even if you see the film right now, ek jagah pe slight change aayega. Facial features ka. The main monster jo hai. You'll see him. So it was full latex prosthetics design. So it's very interesting to do.
I like the addition of the hooves of the character.
Yeah, they had those. The whole point was ke tooth ke hisab se kya hua tha? Gaon mein jhagda ho gaya. Aur geography sir ne bola ke ye aap 100 ghare wale 20 ghar mein aake aap danga kaise kar sakte ho? To 100 ghare ka jo leader tha usne लाठी से बहुत जोर का गुस्सा था, लाठी से ज्योग्राफी सर को मार दिया और उसके बाद क्या हुआ, खाने लगे उसको. दैट्स द लीप वी टुक, कि वो खाने लगे और जैसे ही वो खाए वो बदलने लगे, फिर सब खाने लगे, फिर सब बदलने लगे. अब ये दो बच्चे ही बचे हुए और उनमें से एक जो बच्चा है जो सबसे छोटा है, जिसको पता है कैसे सर्वाइव करना है, उसे पता है कि हिलते हो तो दिखते हो, बोलते हो तो दिखते हो, हिलना डुलना बंद, बोलना चालना बंद, देन यू कैन सर्वाइव. सो दैट्स वेयर वी वर गोइंग. यू नो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग.
सो व्हाट इज लाइक वर्किंग विद एके, ज़ोयाफ़र एंड करंजोल?
एके हु, सॉरी,
अनुराग कश्यप.
अनुराग वीर चुरा के ले आता है. मेरे दिमाग में ये आ गया कि यार ये अपनी ना लाइफ चुरा रहा है. He doesn't have a life, so he's stealing himself a life. Now that's my thing. But now I have to populate it with actual things that he has done. So I speak to cops. I speak to his family. I speak to his associates. And slowly things emerge. Like one of the things that we realized when we were researching Oi Lucky was that whenever I used to speak to a cop, the cop would start smiling. Acha bante, acha. They would always smile, these big, tough cops, you know, like any of the cops, you know, so we will scare you. They will start smiling because they all had some kind of a soft corner for him or some kind of a something for him, in a sense that he was never into too much of a violent crime. He would always steal things which would always intrigue you. Ke teddy bear kyun chura raha hai? Tasveer kyun chura raha hai? Kisi ki tasveer apne flat mein laga di, bola ye mere mata pita hai, you know. So वो सीन है ना कि इसके कितने माँ बाप है, you know? So all of those things came from talking to these cops. For example, the way he escapes, that's also a cop smiling नहीं का. हाँ जी सर, हम वो एयरपोर्ट में प्लेन में थे, उसको लाए, फिर गाड़ी में बैठे, फिर हमने उसको खोल दिया क्योंकि अभी तो जा रहे हैं थाना. तो फिर साहब इधर बैठे हुए थे, मैं इधर बैठा हुआ था, तो थाना आया सुबह के 2 बजे बैठे, मैं इधर से निकल गया, साहब उधर से निकल गए, वो उधर से निकल गया. So literally these things happen when you engage with people and try and approach them in a way that they are not too defensive, or it sometimes it takes time. For example, for Sandeep or Pinky Farrar, Arjun Kapoor, who's a typical Bollywood actor, for him to get into that Jat cop or whatever it is, that kind of a feel, we had to actually get him over to Delhi, and he spent about good 1 month in Delhi meeting all these special branch guys, going to the thanas, seeing an actual interaction happening and all that. We requested one cop, sir, interrogation karte ga, dikha do sir. Agar sir marwaoge kya? You know, हमारा तहलका कर दो गया. मैंने कहा सर कुछ तो दिखा दो ताकि पता तो चले. सो उनका एक खबरी होता था, तो उसने खबरी को फ़ोन किया कि आ जा, थोड़ी एक्टिंग करनी है यार, कोई बॉलीवुड से हीरो है. सो दैट खबरी केम एंड दीज 4-5 कॉप्स डिड अ फोर इंटरोगेशन विद मारा कूटा लाठियों वाटियों से मार के. एंड वी डिडंट टेल अर्जुन, मतलब रियली नहीं मारा, लेकिन वी डिडंट टेल अर्जुन कि ये रियल नहीं है. अर्जुन की फट गई. आई वॉज लाइक I could see the shock, but then he understood that this is the world. From then, that day onwards, he started becoming, Pinky, the cop, you know, because he's in a special branch and they do some pretty horrible things to people. बेटी के साथ छोट
नहीं
his गुरु, that was his theater गुरु. वो उसको बाबजी बोलता है, लेकिन वो थिएटर का गुरु. हाँ सॉरी बट या निकल जाता
है.
That truth is about me feeling guilty about not being there for my older daughter. She was about 3 at that time, and I used to tell her a lot. I'm a storyteller, so I would tell her stories and all that. So that last bit comes from there. By the way, this is not my story. This is a story written by Satyajit Ray. He wrote a fantastic book called Potol Babu Film, a fantastic short story called Potol Babu Film Star. A typical middle class guy in Calcutta, he goes out and his friend says, "Arey yaar, wahan pe kuch extras ko dhoond rahe, tu aaja." So now he used to do theater as a kid, as a young man. Now he's a typical clerk, piss raha hai life mein. It is about that, about a pissa hua guy finding a moment of some kind of a, as you said, expressing the truth. So that's the original story. Again, we took that guy and transplanted him into Bombay. What you see is a chal not very far from my house. And those areas have a history. What happened in the 90s was, in the late 80s, a lot of trade unions in Bombay were broken by political parties so that those mills could be taken over by people to develop as malls or society, you know, high-rise buildings and all that. So, what's up? A political chakkar hai. As a result, pura ka pura ek generation barbaad ho gaya. This guy is an example of that. Wo shuru mein wo factory ki chimneys, if you remember, he's doing. So, he's a dreamer. Who will have an emu in his house? You remember? Emu ka ek business hota tha, aaj se 20 saal pehle, emu egg. कि वो कुछ काफ़ी लोग घुसे भी थे उसमें. देन इट सिर्फ फिनिश लाइक दैट. या सो स्कीम यू नो, सो ही इज़ अ ड्रीमर. ही शुड नेवर हैव बीन इन अ लाइफ वेर ही हैज़ टू प्लान एंड स्कीम. ही शुड हैव बीन एन एक्टर इन अ थिएटर इन अ सोसाइटी विच एक्नोलेजेस द वैल्यू ऑफ एन एक्टर इन अ स्ट्रीट थिएटर. कि तेरे सर पे छत है, तेरे को खाना वाना मिले, तू एक्ट कर. लेकिन उसको वो सोसाइटी नहीं मिली. वो अपने गुरु को बोलता है ना कि मुझे क्या मिला. सो ऑल ऑफ दैट काइंड वी वर काइंड ऑफ ट्राइंग टू टेल दैट व्हाट हैपेंस. बिकॉज बाय द वे अ लॉट ऑफ दीज वेरी ऊबर ड्राइवर्स और फैक्ट्री वर्कर्स एंड ऑल दैट दे हैव ग्रोन अप इन बॉम्बे विद अ वेरी लिविंग ट्रेडिशन ऑफ लोकल थिएटर. मैं भी नाम भूल गया हूँ. एंड दिस वॉज ऑल्सो रिसर्च बाय शबानी एंड समरीन, बाय द वे the same people who researched these. So they did this whole research about Bombay and how these guys sort of, you know, grew up in the 90s and how, so, and all of that kind of dribbled down into the story. So that's how it, so it's the same methodology actually. Good that you brought it up.
And also it's like a Bollywood shoot ka scene.
Ha.
That also has been represented there.
Yeah. हमारे एक्स्ट्रा एक्टर्स जो होते हैं बैकग्राउंड एक्टर्स उनकी एक यूनियन होती है तो जब आप शूट करते हो तो यू हैव टू डू अ यूनियन शूट एंड यू हैव टू कॉल दोज पीपल वो इतने घिसे हुए होते हैं कि उनको देख के रियल आदमी मतलब पता चल जाता है कि ये एक्स्ट्रा है विद अ यूनियन कार्ड क्योंकि अभी वो पेप्सी के एड में यही दिखा था फिर ओवर एक्टिंग करते हैं फिर ऐसे ऐसे पता नहीं क्या अजीब अजीब सी चीजें करते रहते सो यूजुअली अ डायरेक्टर इज ऑलवेज ट्राइंग टू गो अवे फ्रॉम यू नो यूनियन यू नो बैकग्राउंड आर्टिस्ट बट द यूनियन इज ऑल्सो देयर फॉर देयर लिविंग फॉर देयर लाइवलीहुड सो यू ऑल्सो हैव टू यूज इट बिकॉज यू नो दैट दे आर ऑल्सो यू नो डूइंग देयर लाइवलीहुड सो वंस इन अ वाइल फॉर स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स You literally catch somebody from the street and do it. So that's what happened.
And also in these, there's one scene when the Aisha is on the phone with Rajiv, end with a call, and then Rajiv's like, "Udhar pata nahi hai kya ki kya chal raha?" And but she's like, "Ki nahi out."
Ah.
Bed ke baad. Ah. That scene is something that I haven't been able to understand completely. Kya
post? Ah, what kind of scene? The way she was saying, "Thank you." Okay.
I'll have to ask you to think about it. Because समझने का तो कुछ है नहीं क्योंकि वो बोल रहा मैं नहीं आ सकता और वो बोल रही है कि अरे आओ बैठते हैं बात करते हैं और उसके बाद there's a long uncomfortable silence where all they are doing is saying okay to each other. I won't tell you my thought process. Let us say you are having a fight with a date who you really want to go out. It's not because of the date. It's because of whatever's happening. Happens, right? Sometimes you just want to meet some guy because whatever else is happening in your life. Because you feel that that guy or that girl will change things for one evening. All you want is, fuck, I just want to go out and sort of, you know, meet that guy. And when that guy or girl says, listen, yeah, I got this and that and this and that. And then you know that that guy is just giving, you know, he's not wanting to come. What do? It's absolute rejection, right? Complete rejection. So that's what I was actually felt that Manisha Koirala's character felt, that complete rejection. We've all felt it in our lives. These are our truths. Complete rejection. Subah se leke shaam tak kuch kiya aur last mein aisa hua ke you're like fucking going out like blown in your head. Did the day actually go like that? I mean, did I do all of this and did this really happen? So, you know, so it's about complete rejection. I hope so.
Somewhat it's like what you're trying to
Yeah. Yeah. But if you didn't feel it, then probably I wasn't successful. You have to feel it. You have to...
Now that
हाँ वर्ड्स नहीं आते शुरू शुरू में हाँ करेक्ट 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 See, LSD is about our virtual lives, right?
Yeah.
If we are talking about a virtual life, the first thing that you want is an influencer. Somebody who lives, somebody whose life is only virtual. Somebody whose definition of himself or herself is virtual. So that's why the gamer. The reality show was, it started from me wanting a transgender actor. Who is getting into a reality show, facing the, you know, all the problems that you face when you're, you know, LGBTQ. And the middle story, which was Prateek's story, is from a newspaper report. Somewhere in Kochi, there was this station which had a number of transgender employees. वो सारे एक साल में छोड़ के चले गए. तो उसका एक न्यूज़ का एक थोड़ा सा बवाल बना था, बिकॉज दे रियलाइज दैट जस्ट गिविंग देम जॉब्स एंड सेइंग वी आर विद द ट्रांसजेंडर पीपल और द एलजीबीटीक्यू कम्युनिटी इज नॉट इनफ, यू हैव टू डू लॉट्स ऑफ अदर थिंग्स. तब पड़ जाती है, जब पता चलता है कि समाज सुधार एक बटन प्रेस करके नहीं होगा, तो फिर फट जाती है. सो दैट इज द स्टोरी दैट आई थिंक प्रतीक वांटेड टू टेल थ्रू द कैरेक्टर ऑफ स्वस्तिका मुखर्जी, द बॉस, कि शी गेट्स इनटू इट विद दिस. और हमारे बीच में कहावत है कि एलीट जो होते हैं उनको कुछ काम नहीं है, वो घुसते हैं, हगते हैं, गंदा करते हैं और निकल जाते हैं, और किसी काम के नहीं है. कोई भी प्रॉब्लम ले लो, जैसे ही कोई एलीट घुसा ना, वो उसको खराब करके ही निकलेगा. ऐसे ऐसे दिमाग में पॉइंट्स भी होते हैं, इतने अनएक्सपोज्ड होते हो, आपको कुछ हवा नहीं है, क्या हो रहा है उधर, आपके दिमाग में कुछ किताबी आइडियाज़ हैं कि हमें समाज सुधार करना है, हमें ये करना है, वी हैव टू बी दिस, वी हैव टू बी दिस, फिर वो अंग्रेजी में गिटपिट करके आप घुस जाते हो, गंदा करके निकलते हो, एंड विथ योर कॉन्शियस इंटैक्ट के हमने तो बहुत कुछ किया. दीज पीपल आर लाइक दैट, यू नो, सो मेनी टाइम्स यू हर्ड ना समबडी हू इज अ सोशल वर्कर समथिंग, elite social worker, 10 minute baad, but you know these people are like that only, you know, they also don't appreciate what we do for them, and you know they are not educated. By educated they mean they don't speak English, they are not educated, you know, and they are like that. So we wanted ke wo jo hamara gussa hai na elites ka, wo us kahani mein nikle. That's
उसके बाद वो जो सबसे वो वाला क्रेडिट होता है वहां पे हमें लगा शाहरुख आया.
तो वो क्या है कि अब दिस इज समथिंग, हम जब फिल्में बेचते हैं तो फिल्मों में म्यूजिक का बड़ा एक रोल होता है, ठीक है. म्यूजिक कंपनी कुछ पैसे देती है कि भैया ये गाना चलाओ तो तुमको ये लो 20 रुपए और ले लो तुम्हारे बजट के लिए, ठीक है. ये दिस इज द वे फिल्म्स आर फाइनेंस्ड, इंडिया में ही है और कहीं नहीं होता. सो अभी क्या हुआ कि आजकल म्यूजिक कंपनीज, they don't want you to make the film and put the music in it, they want you to do the music that they want and put the film in it. So kyunki unka apna koi rapper hai jiske 20 million views hai, usne usko nichodna hai, to sir iska le lo na sir, badshah ka gana le lo sir, to ya kuch kar lo ya ye kar lo. To usi type se choices in work de to sir aapko 20 rupaye nahi denge, to wo 20 rupaye lene ke liye wo karna padta hai, last mein dal dete hain wo. Lekin mere ko acha laga ki wo apni wo virtual life jiye ja raha hai apni wo girlfriend ke sath jo bhi ho raha hai, to maine usko kar diya.
It was short, it was short.
No, I wasn't even there, which is good, which is good. I wasn't even, I said video hai na, dal do sir. This is the way you kind of.
So our take was that you were mocking the mainstream Bollywood.
Oh, I was mocking throughout, but not intentionally. Ask.
Do you think it's a cool thing that your film is getting backlash
also? Good question.
I think it's pretty cool, honestly.
You think it's pretty cool that I can see, but. See, what happened was that we made it and we were all very happy with it. The whole team, bahut jaan lagayi thi film mein, bahut jaan lagayi thi. And we also understood at that point, the whole team, the actors, the cinematographer, the, you know, writers, that, okay, we've done something new. Okay? Agreed? And then we thought, Netflix hai, sab dekhenge, kitna maza aayega. Slowly and slowly it started trickling to us, and Netflix never told us openly धीरे 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 विल टेल यू धीरे धीरे इट्स नॉट द राइट टाइम टू रिलीज. 6-7-8 महीने हो गए थे. देन दैट यू नो इट वॉज कोविड टाइम एंड वी शॉट द फिल्म इन द मिडल ऑफ कोविड. वी वर शूटिंग द फिल्म, कोविड स्टार्टेड हैपनिंग. देन वी टुक अ ब्रेक फॉर 8 months. देन आई री इमेजिन्ड द फिल्म. दैट मेट्रो स्टेशन इज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ कोविड. सो गुड थिंग्स हैपन. Earlier it was some other location, some big location where I was trying to show my future design, you know. But that never happened like that. We finished the film with tremendous effort and problems. After that, to be told that it's not going to be shown, it's not going to festivals, it's not going to be screened in LA as our plan was. But everybody wants to be famous, everybody wants to be known, everybody wants to be feted. Wo sab nahi hua. And it was a big one. So, I mean, again, my therapist bills again went up. It's true. It's absolutely. So you have to sort of, you know, support yourself and get your mental act health cleaned out, you know. So, no, man. I mean, I really would have loved this film to be seen. And you know what? Another thing, the heartbreaking thing is, I made this film for the same audience as Khosla Ka Ghosla. This wasn't LSD 2, na? LSD 2, I can imagine, my, you know, some uncle, auntie, ho bhi chuka hai ke gussa ho gaye hain wo dekh ke. You know, gussa aa raha hai unko. You know, they've really reacted badly to the film because it completely attacks them. You can see yourself in the film and then you can't live with it. But this wasn't like that. This was about an Indian family. I mean, I call it my hum log. You know what I'm saying? Or whatever, bunya, chunya, jo bhi hota hai. You know, it's a story of a family. And my dream was that the audience of Khosla Ka Ghosla will watch it. And I would have found a lot of happiness with that. Wo nahi hua. So, no. But you think it's cool.
You were making a tricky film. You didn't know that?
No, I didn't know. Because you yourself, somebody said, okay, you see the KP side, you see the Muslim side, you see the side. I've even shown it because, okay, yaar, Dibakar, isme kya hai? Isme kyun band kar? Isme dekh ke sadness aata hai, ek ajeeb si feeling aati hai. Lekin aisa to kuch nahi hai ki yaar, jaise kuch, you know. That's what I meant when that gentleman, Daya, was asking that, you know, you have to go with your truth and then you have to live with the fact that somebody does not want to confront truth. In my opinion, I think, I mean, of course, I mean, after the film is made, it's very easy to look at it in hindsight and give it sort of, you know, nice, pithy analysis. But I think it's about cultural appropriation.
Cultural appropriation.
I think it's about Usha telling, see, Aisha is ambitious. Aisha is smart. Aisha doesn't, you can see that she's always maneuvering around. She's getting Rajiv over. She's speaking to Usha's husband for her husband's problems. So Aisha is a maneuverer to in the end also, you can see. So, and that's what I liked about Aisha. So Aisha is telling Usha ki chal dono milke likhte hain. This is something that I could have done. Not understanding in my ambition and in my maneuvering what the other person is feeling. That other person is also on the way to becoming an angry and slightly bigoted person. As of now, that person is not bigoted. But the journey to bigotry comes with a heightened impression to yourself about your privilege and your power and your importance. And when the world changes, then you start getting angry. So I sort of, you know, she's saying that, why do you want our food? You're driving us away. Why do you want our food? Exactly what a Muslim can say today, na? So that's what I wanted.
And the last
character. Tandoori chicken or kebab ke bina north mein hum jee payenge? Nahi, vegetarian jo wo sahi hai. Lekin baaki jo north mein agar tandoori chicken nikal jaye अगर क्या कहते हैं कबाब निकल जाए, अगर समोसा निकल जाए, जी पाओगे? सब कुछ धरा का धरा रह जाएगा. सो दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस, हाउ कल्चर्स कम टुगेदर एंड क्रिएट अ लाइफ ऑफ थिंग्स वेयर वी फॉरगेट द रूट्स एंड वी थिंक इट्स आवर्स एंड दैट्स द वे टू बी. बट देन सडनली यू कांट चेरी पिक के दिस इज आवर्स एंड दैट इज योर्स एंड दिस इज वेयर यू कम एंड वी विल चेरी पिक एंड टेक द समोसा फ्रॉम यू बट वी विल नॉट लेट यू डू दिस. दैट्स व्हाट आई वांटेड. अभी वो इट्स अ हाइंडसाइट एट दैट पॉइंट. इट्स जस्ट अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फाइट बिटवीन टू आंटीज एंड आई एम रियली हैप्पी दैट आई डिड दैट सीन बिकॉज अ गाय लाइक मी being able to write and do that scene about two aunties fighting over a cookbook, it's a great thing. I mean, I kind of take some pride in that, that I could write a scene like that. Because I've seen my mom, my aunties and all that, you know, whatever, whatever.
But that cookbook comes back in the end.
Yeah, that cookbook comes back because that cookbook becomes the chance for Anhad to get published. साइड से बिकॉज ऑल ऑफ अस मनूवर राइट. और आई मीन वी डोंट चंड आउट मेरी. बाय द वे डू यू सी द सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन अनहद्स लाइफ एंड माय लाइफ? आई डिडंट एक्सपेक्ट दिस. आई डिडंट नो दैट इट वुड बिकम सेमी ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल इन रेट्रोस्पेक्ट यू नो. सो इट्स क्रेजी. सो आई एम सेइंग दैट दैट बिकेम अ साइड से कि मैं ऐसे करके मैं ऐसे कर दूंगा निकल जाऊंगा फिर मैं पब्लिश करूंगा. यही तो हमने भी सोचा है ना कि ये LSD2 बना लूंगा, 30 बना लूंगा नेटफ्लिक्स में, फिर LMA हो जाएगा, सब बोलेंगे क्या अच्छी फिल्म है, क्या अच्छी फिल्म है. एंड आई वुड हैव डन माय बिट फॉर इंडिया एंड कम्युनल हारमोनी एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड टॉलरेंस एंड ऑल दैट. ऐसे नहीं होता है, यू हैव टू पे अ प्राइस व्हिच आर पेइंग नाउ. These things happen in real life, in I feel, in real accidents. Huma's character and her partner, they are having their life. Her partner, who is displaced by Huma's character's displacement about whatever's happening with their flat, probably has a fleeting scene with another guy in her office. वो बोलते हैं तुम कितना bi curious बनना है यार. तो वो bi curious बन के कुछ हो गया. She got pregnant. क्या पता Huma के character को लगा होगा यार why should I not have this kid? We were anyways planning to have a kid. In fact, it gives someone like Huma a way to hold on to her partner even stronger without making it apparent. ऐसे ही तो करते हैं ना हम हमारी लाइफ में अपने लवर से, अपने पार्टनर से बता के नहीं करते, साइड से करते हैं. You know, happens. So, we don't even know ourselves. So she does it. अब उनका बच्चा हो गया. अब बच्चा होने के बाद जो भी हुआ बॉम्बे में, 30 के राइड्स हुए, जो भी हुए, वो बच्चे को लेके वो दिल्ली चले गए. उसके बाद नानी ने अनहद को वापस नहीं जाने दिया. करेक्ट. उसका नाम है अनहद. मदर का नाम द्राबू है. अब स्कूल में जब आप एडमिशन के लिए जाओगे तो अच्छा अनहद, हाँ द्राबू, चलो उस टाइम पे बस एडमिशन के लिए तो लिखेंगे ना द्राबू, लिख दिया. ऐसे ही हमारी आइडेंटिटीज बनती. डज इट साउंड टू इम्प्लॉजिबल? बिकॉज दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस. बट व्हाट आई फाइंड स्लाइटली नॉट वरिंग, व्हाट आई फाइंड पीपल लाइक यू जिनके हाथ पे, जिनके हाथों में पूरा देश है, तुम कंधों में कल तुम, तुम्हारा देश तुम्हारा होगा, हम तो चले जाएंगे एंड ऑल दैट. बट इफ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द सॉफ्ट स्पेसेस बिटवीन पीपल देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द सॉफ्ट स्पेसेस बिटवीन कम्युनिटीज एंड जेंडर्स एंड अंडरस्टैंड दैट अदराइजिंग is the easiest thing, and not otherizing is something that comes with an effort, but it's the most natural thing to us. It's because we've been conditioned to otherize all the time. The first otherizing happens because of patriarchy. The second otherizing might happen because of some political dispensation. The third otherizing may happen because of money, social differences or whatever. So ultimately, if you start otherizing, then wahi hoga. Sab alag alag ho jaoge. Koi community nahi rahegi, koi action nahi hoga. Ek hi ghar mein husband ek cigarette piyega, wife ek aur cigarette piyegi. That is the triumph of capitalism. Ki ladkiyon ke liye cigarette. So these are the kind of things that are within our spaces that we need to identify and make them our truths. That's what I feel. That's the polemicist. That's the jhanda carrying side of me. In the early years, I used to do it with humor. You must have seen it. Khosla mein hai humor, Lucky mein hai humor. So humor comes easy to me. So we humor se karta tha, music se karta tha, dialogue bazi se karta tha. Abhi as I'm aging, to tell you the truth, abhi utna karne ka man nahi karta. If you see Khosla ka Khosla, and if you see Tees, I don't think you can tell that the same person has made them. So I have changed. And I have come to a stage where I am now openly sort of, you know, thinking of not worrying about how will I entertain. Because I think I want to engage rather than entertain. अब इसके बाद कोई बोले यार तू फिल्म मेकर है तू क्यों समाज सुधारक बनना चाहता है तो हर एक के अपने अपने भसूड़े होते हैं यू हैव टू कैरी इट सो आई मीन आई एम कैरिंग इट व्हाटएवर सॉरी कंटेंट बेसिकली यू टॉक अबाउट द प्लेटफॉर्म्स राइट See, I started doing things like Bombay Talkies, Lust Stories, Ghost Stories and other such things. Plus I make ad films. In ad films, you deal with shallow things. Right now, tomorrow, day after, I'm shooting a film for Coke. So it's all about color blocking and kya kapde pehnega, ye sab wo sab chalega to. Society sab gaya udhar. So पीछे Volkswagen Beetle जाएगी you know background car में so वो सब चलेगा so you I my practice comes from that but also to tell you that I don't want to be trendy or with it in terms of the content because platform content because as you have seen you may have seen like I have stopped watching Netflix for the last 2 to 3 years Because it all looks the same, it all feels the same, the actors are the same. Why? Because there are about 30 executives sitting there telling the content maker ki tum aise banao aur is character ko maar do aur is character ko zinda rakho aur isko aise karo. So I genuinely don't want to get into that. So what I'm trying to do is that I am trying to make films which are theatrical. And if they are content films, if they're platform films, then I get financed completely first, make the film, and then sell it to the content. And also going cheaper and cheaper. And going more, jisko hum bina samjhe so no, thoda aur leftist. So going even more leftist. So I'm definitely not doing what you're asking if I'm doing. Yeah.
In terms of content, we don't now watch things which are unique, but we get to see things which are most of the people are watching.
Yeah.
That's the algorithm
yeah.
which had
yes.
created by
yes.
us.
Yes.
So how do you then make way for new content? Like, how do you know it's reaching the audience?
It's the only way you can make new content in this environment is to risk your existence. So that's what's happening. And while risking your existence, you have to be smart enough to maneuver and survive. Let's say something like what Aisha is doing. So definitely what's happening with the content world, with the Netflixes of the world and all that, is that if I give an analogy, you call for an Uber. Uber aata hai, kahan jana hai? Vasant Vihar. Vasant Vihar kyun jaoge yaar? Connaught Place chalo. So the aggregator, a site which is supposed to aggregate content, where the algorithm is supposed to help you classify, aggregate better, is actually now dictating what you see, what you get to see, and what you don't get to see. Itna sab kuch Netflix sab kuch aa gaya hai, theek hai? Ek bhi koi famous international film bol do jo mil jayegi idhar. Hollywood ki nahi. Thodi si hat jao bas, thodi si. Thoda sa hat ke. Milegi? Aapko Raid tak nahi milegi. Kisi ne Raid dekhi hai? Indonesian ek wo hai. Action film hai. रेड तक नहीं मिलेगी यार. रेड के लिए पायरेट बे जाना पड़ेगा. घोसला का घोसला नहीं मिलेगी, पायरेट बे जाना पड़ेगा. सो दैट इज व्हाट एल्गोरिथम इज डूइंग. व्हाट एल्गोरिथम इज डूइंग इज दैट, एंड दिस इज नॉट ओनली हैपनिंग इन कंटेंट, दिस इज हैपनिंग इन एवरी स्फीयर ऑफ आवर लाइव्स, दैट अबाउट 4 or 5 मेगा कंपनीज एंड द एल्गोरिथम इज डिसाइडिंग your psychic life, what you wake up with and what you go to sleep with. The platforms are openly talking about binge watching. Imagine koi dawai bechne wala bol raha hai sabko addict bana dunga. Ye wo bol raha hai, uska stated aim hai. Wo sarkar ko bol raha hai ki sir maine ye dawai banayi hai, sab addicted ho jayenge, main din raat ye dekhenge और यही चीज देखते रहेंगे और सेम कार. सो बिंज वॉचिंग, दे आर सेइंग दैट दे डोंट वांट यू टू लीव योर लैपटॉप स्क्रीन्स और फोन स्क्रीन्स. दे आर सेइंग दैट यू शुड सी व्हाट वी आस्क यू टू सी. दे आर सेइंग दैट यू आर ऑन इंस्टा, यू आर ऑन दिस, यू आर ऑन दिस, जस्ट गो टू दिस एंड टैप दिस एंड यू वॉच, एंड यू आर सीइंग व्हाट दे वॉन्ट यू टू वॉच, एंड यू योर सेल्फ आर सीइंग दैट एवरीथिंग इज द सेम. सो अभी आपको देखना है कि आप कितना एल्गोरिदम से निकलोगे. ये तो हो रहा है एंड वी आर ऑल इंडेंजर्ड. देर आर मेनी बुक्स एंड इवन इन डिजाइन एंड ऑल, आई गेस यू रीड मेनी सच बुक्स विच आर मैपिंग द फ्यूचर दैट्स देयर टू कम. एंड वॉट हैपन्स इज दैट वेन यू आर कंटिन्यूसली इंजेक्टेड विद दिस ना, अंदर ही अंदर एक एंगर रिएक्शन आता है. लेकिन वो एंगर नेटफ्लिक्स या ट्रंपिज्म या उसके खिलाफ नहीं जाता है, वो एंगर अपने भाई की तरफ जाता है. अपने भाई से बात करना बंद कर देते हो क्योंकि आप ऐसे ऐसे बढ़, या अपने पेरेंट्स से बात करना बंद कर देते हो, या बाहर जाना बंद कर देते हो, या यू नो यू बिकम आइलैंड्स, यू नो. सो दैट्स द फिनोमेनन. यू गाइस विल हैव टू फिगर आउट व्हाट टू डू, क्योंकि दुनिया तुम्हारे ऊपर है, हमारा टाइम तो चला गया. वो ब्योमकेश की कहानियों में ही है. ब्योमकेश जो लिखते थे, उनका नाम था शौरदेन्दु बैनर्जी, वो लिखते थे. ही स्टार्टेड राइटिंग इन 30s एंड 30s से लेके 40s, 50s, 60s तक उन्होंने लिखा. तो ये जो कहानी थी ये 40s में बेस्ड थी. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई मेड इट. And Sharadindu Banerjee had a style of writing which used to bring that time of Calcutta very, very alive. Also, I wanted to, because I grew up as a Bengali kid, reading amazing amounts of, literature for preteens and children. मतलब magazines, किताबें, comic books सब बंगाली में बचपन में पढ़ता था. बहुत है, अभी भी होती हैं, उस टाइम पे बहुत ज़्यादा थी. तो वो पढ़ और उसमें एडवेंचर स्टोरीज, डिटेक्टिव स्टोरीज, धाएँ धाएँ, ये सब बहुत कुछ होता था. सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर, नाजी वॉर, ये सब बहुत कुछ हम पढ़ के ना दिमाग में वही घूमता रहता था. सो आई मेड ब्योमकेश वन एज अ विजिट टू द एडोलेसेंट लाइफ ऑफ माइन, वेयर आई वुड रीड दोज ग्राफिक नॉवल्स एंड दोज एडवेंचर नॉवल्स. हिंदी में भी होती थी 70s-80s में, राजन इकबाल, डिटेक्टिव शिट है, बहुत बहुत फेमस होते थे. वो हार्डी बॉयज के कवर चुरा के उनको प्रिंट करके अंदर राजन इकबाल की कहानियाँ होती थी. वो देवर डिटेक्टिव्स और व्हाटएवर व्हाटएवर. सो दैट पल्प फिक्शन, पल्प जो होता है वो मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लगता है. तो दैट्स व्हाई आई मेड ब्योमकेश वन लाइक दैट. द कैरेक्टर सारे शरदिंदु बनर्जी लिख के गए थे. ब्योमकेश, उसका दोस्त अजीत, डॉक्टर गुहा, सत्यवती, जो भी मेन कैरेक्टर्स थे ना वो कहानियों में हैं, उनकी कहानियों में, उनकी एक दो कहानियों में है. उन्होंने करीब 30 या 32 ब्योमकेश की कहानियाँ लिखी थी. उसमें से एक या दो कहानियों में इन कैरेक्टर्स को मतलब ब्योमकेश तो हर कहानी में, अजीत भी हर कहानी में, सत्यवती उसकी वाइफ हर कहानी में, लेकिन ये डॉक्टर गुहा और ये सब एक दो कहानियों में इनका प्रीक्वल सीक्वल करके उन्होंने बड़ा अच्छा बनाया था. तो वो पहला मैंने बनाया. एंड ब्योमकेश टू आई एम राइटिंग वेयर आई एम कैचिंग इट इन 1947. इंडिपेंडेंस इज अबाउट टू कम एंड डॉक्टर गुहा इज बैक विथ एन ईविल स्कीम. विल टेक अनदर एक्टर यार, किसी के लिए कुछ रुकना नहीं चाहिए. फ्लो करो, इट्स सैड बट फ्लो. प्रोडक्शन डिजाइन वॉज डन बाय सम वन पर्सन फ्रॉम NID एंड वन पर्सन वॉज एक्चुअली डूइंग द प्रोडक्शन डिजाइन फॉर माई एड फिल्म राइटर मोनिका भौमिक. शी वर्क्स फ्रॉम दिल्ली. सो
talk about visual language of the movie. What is going to be the visual language? Is it going to be through production design, through camera angles, moment of camera? How do you decide it? How do you discuss amongst the team
ki kya hone
wala visual language?
I'll take Byomkesh. Let's say Byomkesh ki kahani likhi and then I presented to the team the graphic novels and the comic books and the preteen sort of the teenage books that I had from 70s and 80s. So I opened them up and those guys got to see the drawing styles, the illustration style, the colors and everything. And because they were mostly pulp and crime fiction, they were heavily invested into night. So it's about how to make night visible. Night mein to andhera ho jata hai, lekin how to use the lamp post, how to use the shaft of the headlight of a car, how to use fog, how to use water, all those things, okay? So that was one thing. They look at this world, this is what I grew up in, and I wanted the cinematographer and the production designer to see ki bas mereko aisa kuch ek look chahiye. So that was one part of it. The second part of it was that we did research and we found this splendid album. You'll find it in Google right now if you go. There were these American Air Force guys who were stationed in Calcutta during 1945, 42, 43. They used to take photos. And there is this huge album of about 70 photos in PenU, Pennsylvania University. Pura ek album usne wo university ko dekhe gaya. To wo hai public domain mein. So we took those high-res photographs. That was Calcutta exactly at that time. In that, we got the texture. They were black and white photos. So we had color here and we had the reality over there in terms of what are the clothes that they're wearing, what is the kind of hairstyle, what are the kind of buildings, roads, cars, rickshaws. In addition to that, those also form the guide for all the crowd scenes. You see, today's crowd is very different from 1942's crowd. 1942 mein ek banda will have a buffalo hide bag on his bag with a pipe which he used to water down the streets. Usko bolte the bhishti. Wo subah aake pani dalta tha taki the dust would settle down. So those kind of things, how would the trams look? So all of that came from my vision of what I wanted that world to be and what that world historically was at that time. You sit and do a complete visual presentation and discussion. There are about 300, 400 images. You meet over it over 4 or 5 days, discuss it. The cinematographer sits with the production designer. You discuss the color palette, color blocking, and then you start going from there. That's what happened.
You haven't lived that life, so how do you get that reference?
The discussion went something like this. It was me, production designer. That's a very good question. Is that what would happen, let's say 20 years from the first thing? So everybody said pollution. So pollution, hua ya, jo bhi hua, whatever. Now what happens in a pollution in a politically draconian society? Maybe they have air purifiers. Maybe those air purifiers can be funded by Adani Ambani also, right? Those purifiers can be funded by the government also. What if the government does a private-public partnership? Ke pure desh ke purifier aap lega lo. Sir, laga denge ji. Lekin kya hai ke Pusa Road mein na 1 million क्यूबिक चाहिए. अब इसके लिए क्या है कि अगर बहुत ज़्यादा लोग आ जाएं तो फिर काम नहीं करेगा. तो हम ना लोगों को कलिंग करना चालू कर देंगे कि सुबह 9 से 10 बजे तक ऑफिस टाइम में इतने लोग आ सकते हैं, 10 से 6 बजे तक इतने लोगों की परमिट है. दैट वुड बी द रियल सोल्यूशन ना, कि अडानी अंबानी को प्रॉफिट तो बनाना ही है ना. सो दैट थिंग ऑफ परमिट कि आप इस जोन में इसके बाद नहीं आ सकते क्योंकि जरूरत से ज्यादा ऑक्सीजन कर इज बीइंग स्पेंट. सो दैट आइडिया केम फ्रॉम देयर. देन वी थॉट ऑफ अनदर थिंग दैट पेपर वुड बी एबल टू हैव मूविंग इमेजेस. सो आई मीन आई एम श्योर वेरी सून वील हैव पेपर. Right now, a Chinese company has made a completely foldable phone. It becomes a big tablet and it becomes a folded phone. So we did folding screens. We thought of printable paper. Okay. Then we thought of holograms, which will become very common. Holograms are there today. 20 years from now, holograms will be like the way TV screens are today. Stuff like that. So you take what's there, you take what's not there and kind of do a balance between them. You do a narrative story through all those things which I said in the beginning, the political part of it, the technological part of it, the design part of it, the human sociological part of it, and then you kind of intertwine them.
Okay, I have a question. The film is called Peace. There are some references about Peace. Not explicitly explained at all. What's the truth?
See, originally the film was called Ghar. Ab ek film thi Rekha ki, Vinod Mehra ki Ghar. To uske baad I had to figure out what to sort of do. So I told Netflix ke chalo others rakh lo or something like that. Then I think it came down to the safest title, which was this riot that happened but didn't happen in 2030, which is Anhad's childhood memory, which is also about his book. So like that, 2030.
What do you mean by happened but didn't happen? Because that's what you feel in the film as well.
Yes, yes. Because the government has, according to me, has suppressed. It has unhappened. You see, we unsee and we unhappen many things that are happening all around us. So it's the unhappening. It's the unexisting of something that may have existed. एक और वो बोलता है कि जब वो अनंत बोलता है ना कि वो स्विमिंग पूल में डाल मार के नीचे डाल दिया एंड ऑल दैट. तो उसमें एक लाइन था नीले नीले पानी में काली काली लाशें. वो गाता है, वो ही इज इम्प्रेसिंग हिज गर्लफ्रेंड ना कि मैं कितना अच्छा हूँ ये हूँ. तो लेकिन वो राइट्स के लिए हम नहीं कर पाए. So it was making that thing. So I had this image of a Bombay high rise and burnt bodies floating in the blue pool Because for me, that was the first time that writing entered the middle class and upper middle class high rises in Bombay in 2013. जो हम नहीं सोच सकते वो हो गया. वो तो काफी कुछ चीजें हम नहीं सोच सकते थे, वो हो गई. तो ऐसी भी एक चीज होगी कि हम सोचते हैं कि राइट्स उधर होते हैं, लेकिन एक दिन शायद ऐसा आ जाए कि हमारे हाई राइज में, गुड़गांव में राइट्स हो जाए और हम अभी नो पीपल आर बर्नड एंड ड्रॉप्ड फ्रॉम द बालकनी इनटू द पूल बिलो. सो दैट्स द विजन दैट आई हैव.
सो प्लीज, देयर इज अ सीन वेयर अनदर इज नॉट अलाउड टू लीव द मेट्रो स्टेशन बिकॉज़ ऑफ दिस लो सोशल.
ही इज नॉट अलाउड टू स्टे देयर एंड ही इज नॉट अलाउड टू लीव.
सो सर, देयर जब वो निकल नहीं पा रहा तो फिर सडनली द लोकल्स कम, दे स्टार्ट विद द प्ले डांस. तो उस समय सडनली आपका सीन में रेड आई मीन स्लाइडिंग ओवर हुई, ऑडियो के साथ हम खेल रहे हैं, रिवर्स सीक्वेंसेस ऑफ पीस गेम हो रहे हैं. तो हाउ डिड यू कम अप विद दिस अप्रोच, बिकॉज दिस इज टोटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ द स्टाइल ऑफ द मूवी.
सी, इट्स अ क्लाइमैक्स इन सम वेज, इट्स द एक्सप्लोजन. What happens is that अभी उन्होंने वहाँ पे नाच रहे हैं, ठीक है, नाचेंगे तो वहाँ पे वो सायरन आएगा ही आएगा. अगर सायरन आएगा फिर उसने एक लाइट तोड़ दी, जैसे ही लाइट तोड़ दी, पुलिस स्टेशन में सेंसर है, वो ऑटोमेटिकली इंफ्रा रेड और रेड यू नो चालू कर देगा ताकि कोई बच ना पाए, सब दिख जाए, ठीक है. देन आग, अगर कोई आगजनी करे उसके डर से ऑटोमेटिकली पानी आ जाएगा, जो अभी भी हो सकता है, ठीक है. उसके बाद आई जस्ट शॉर्ट एंड स्लो मोशन, बिकॉज शादी में नाचने आए थे, वहां पे कुछ हो गया और अब सबको मजा आ रहा है, तोड़ो मैच, तोड़ो तोड़ो तोड़ो. सो होता है ना, हमने खुद देखा हुआ है, जब तोड़ने का जब मूड आता है तो सब तोड़ते हैं ना. तो वो तोड़ रहे हैं और उसके चक्के सेंसर से जो हो रहा है वो हो रहा है, एंड आई एम जस्ट पुटिंग स्लो मोशन एंड म्यूजिक टू इट, दैट्स ऑल.
In the kitchen she used to actually cook Bengali foods on the set. How much it helps
देख, वो वंदना का दिमाग खराब है, ठीक है. उसको वहां पे बंगाली फूड बना के उसको मूड आया होगा तो होगा, मैंने नहीं बनाया, मुझे जरूरत नहीं पड़ी. लेकिन वो आई मीन यू नो व्हाट एवर फ्लोट्स योर बोट, सो बस ठीक है, मेरे को नहीं पड़ी जरूरत. शी वॉन्टेड टू लिव देयर. या हम शूट पे वहां पे आते थे, फिर अपने होटल में आते थे, आई वांट टू स्लीप, चलो रहो. सो बिकॉज व्हाट हैड हैपेंड वाज द रियल स्टोरी इज के दैट डिजाइन, दैट बिल्डिंग इज द लिटरली वी हैव टेकन अ बिल्डिंग फ्रॉम कैलकटा एंड मेड दैट, वी लिटरली मेड इट, देन दैट चेंज्ड द शूटिंग, बिकॉज फिर वो उसके अंदर घुस गए. ऐसा नहीं है कि ये रूम इधर सेट पेट, पूरा घर ही बना डाला. So, I mean, thank God we could do it. So, that sort of, you know, did a lot of, when that set came down, those streets and all that, you know, heart broke. It was like, we had planned it in a way and we had prefaced it in a way that we were using each and every part of that, you know, set in various ways.
Why did you choose this sequence in these, as in... all the generations, why did you put in this specific model? It could have worked as 1989.
हाँ, ये हमने कल सुना, एक स्क्रिप्ट राइटर आया था हमारा, अनुराधा तिवारी, इसे नाम.
I think I've heard.
हाँ, so she was telling us that people first write a story, which is a linear story, and then they add structure to it by doing this. Is that how you do it?
Not always. Sometimes when you're sometimes when you know that बाद में तोड़ना ही है, तो sometimes you need to tell yourself कि मैं क्यों तोड़ रहा हूँ. बिल्कुल, तो वो क्यों तोड़ने का आंसर अपनी मर्जी के हिसाब से तोड़ के क्या अच्छा लग रहा है, क्या बुरा लग रहा है, उसे पता चलता है. आई थिंक 30 में डेफिनेटली आई डिडंट वॉन्ट टू कन्फ्यूज एनीबडी. I wanted to start with the future, go to the middle and go to the past, and then keep that same order and see wherever we can go. I think towards the end, we kind of got it. Because Gaurav Solanki, the writer, and I, we knew that we had four stories. The three stories and the fourth story, the film, which we used to call the super story. So we knew or tried to know as much as possible ki kis vakat kya emotion, kya impact kya chahiye. And that's how we weaved the three times. So the three stories were servicing the super story. So that's how we kind of wrote it. Yeah, very consciously. I mean, kafi time gaya usko
likhna. In the movie, you mentioned 89 insurgency and other riots, or the burning the building and riots of 2030, but and also Zia's death. But you didn't show it. Is there any reason? Like, I mean, it did work as it was, but was there any reason?
I think the story was about Zia being alive and Zia being dead at the same time. That's what you get, right? Because of the unique structure of the times. So that was the, that's why we, that's how we broke it. Wo todne ka maksad wo tha ki ek banda zinda hai aur 5 minute baad wahi banda genuinely nahi hai. So that I wanted to, because films can give you a position that you in your real life can never have. Books and films give you that position. सो दैट पोजिशन में आप दोनों चीज़ें देख रहे हो. आप एक चीज़ में देख रहे हो कि एक बच्चा है, दूसरी सीन में देख रहे हो कि वही नसीरुद्दीन शाह बूढ़ा होके कुछ गालियाँ वालियाँ बक रहा है, कुछ उल जुलूल हरकतें कर रहा है, वट एवर. सो दैट्स ऑल्सो यू लिविंग विद दैट ओल्ड मैंस चाइल्डहुड एंड ओल्ड एज एट द सेम टाइम. दैट्स द यूनिक लेंस दैट वी वॉन्टेड एंड दैट्स वाई वी ब्रोक इट, यू नो. And you see people like that. अपने जिनकी भी पुरानी अलाहाबाद वलाहाबाद में जिनके भी पुराने घर होंगे वहाँ पर एक ऐसा होगा जो 40 साल से है घर में. गवर्नमेंट वो 10 साल की उम्र में घर आया होगा, फिर दादाजी ने 17 साल की उम्र में पोस्ट ऑफिस में लगवा दिया होगा, फिर पोस्ट ऑफिस में उसने 30 साल की नौकरी भी की और रात को आके खाना भी पकाता था, और अब वो बूढ़ा हो गया है और अब वो अकेले वो घर संभाल रहा है. स्टफ लाइक दैट. सो दीज आर ऑल आर लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ द ग्रेट इंडियन फैमिली. दैट आल्सो वी वांटेड टू ब्रिंग इट.
इफ यू कुड फ्रॉम अ वेरी बॉलीवुड पर्सपेक्टिव,
हां जी,
टेक अ 30 सेकंड वीडियो दैट एनकैप्सुलेट्स योर विजन ऑफ इंडिया टुडे, व्हाट डू यू थिंक वुड बी द फर्स्ट एंड लास्ट इमेज?
अ 30 सेकंड
बॉलीवुड पर्सपेक्टिव
फ्रॉम माय फिल्म्स. From my film?
Yeah. Taken from Star.
What do you mean by Bollywood perspective?
Just inside the world of your fiction. Jo aapki films
hai. Haan, but that's like kind of marginal Bollywood. That's not real Bollywood. Anyway, I'll kind of... So, you're asking which 30 seconds kind of...
Yeah, the 30 seconds especially... The
whichever kind of dearest to me, yeah. Abhi ke liye. I would say the last sequence of LSD 2. I mean, it doesn't even have any real actors in it. By the way, that was shot with motion capture. We did facial and body motion capture and we put it into the metaverse. So it's like the ultimate going away from any traditional way of filmmaking. So that's my favorite, because I mean, I didn't even use people to shoot it.
So that brings me to one more question. What's a story you would love to tell, but are terrified that no audience would ever understand?
No. I would rather answer that at what's the story that I would love to tell, but I will not get the budget for. That's a more workable premise for me. That story is a very interesting... real story about what happened in Afghanistan in 1845. It's a fascinating story about colonialism. It's a fascinating story about the empire. It's a fascinating story about South Asia. and it encapsulates ke ek desh mein ek raja aane wala tha aur teen char colonial powers jo us desh mein hai hi nahi, unhone kaha nahi ye nahi ho sakta. Uske baad 2 saal hazaron life, hazaron zindagiyan, ladai, jhagda, 10 saal ke baad wahi raja fir se aur unhone hi bithaya. And the colossal waste in between. So that to me is also a very telling tale of colonialism and empire. Jiska bhasuda abhi tak hum jee rahe. It's still not, we're still, oh totally, we are living in the shadow of, I mean, I'm not that event, I'm talking about colonialism and empire. We are, I mean, you cannot define us as Indians if you do not take in colonialism and the project of the empire. I mean, you might think, ye kya bol raha hum to, you know, but you'll have to, if you read up history, you'll get to know. Our identities are deeply intertwined with that concept. Absolutely. Aur angrezi mein aise baat kar rahe hain ke 80% ko samajh mein nahi aa raha hai. Aur humne sabko angrezi nahi sikhai. और हमने अंग्रेजी वैसे ही यूज की जैसे अंग्रेज यूज कर रहे थे, टू कीप आउट 80% एंड टू यू नो, सो दैट्स द एम्पायर प्रोजेक्ट एंड वी आर, दिस इज द इंडियन एम्पायर ऑफ द इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग एलीट. जिसके खिलाफ जब गुस्सा निकलता है तो गुस्सा निकलने का कोई रास्ता नहीं मिलता तो लोग राम बोलते हैं, वो भी है. सो यू कैनॉट टेक अवे द एम्पायर एक्सरसाइज आउट ऑफ even one aspect of our life today.
How do you approach the initial stage of developing a film idea? Is it through a character, a theme, or a visual concept? Like how, what's the one starting?
It can be any of the three or a combination of two or three.
For you, what is it?
It keeps changing. For Khosla, it was like the father and son. For Oye Lucky, it was this thief, but it was much more beyond the thief. For Byomkesh, it was the whole Calcutta world, you know. Thieves, we've discussed, LSD2, we've discussed. So it keeps changing. But ghost stories, because they said make ghost stories. Ultimately, you have to do what you have to do. So you take that as an excuse and then somehow maneuver to do what you have to do. I wanted to make a zombie film, so.
What about
Come again?
Bombay Talkies.
Bombay Talkies, it started with, see, again, they said that it should be about cinema. I found this Satyajit Ray story very interesting about cinema, that wo banda jaake usko pata bhi nahi kya ho raha hai. So, and I, the whole thing was that, about that shot of the film, where you don't see Ranbir Kapoor even for once. But you keep hearing and all that, but your camera stays with this extra who has done one A like that. So for me, that's how it started. Sort of, you know, to go away from Ranbir Kapoor and look at the extra.
What about LSD?
LSD1 started with a short film that was about the beheading story. Then I wrote another short film, which was about the supermarket story, the CCTV camera. And that I wrote before Khosla Ka Ghosla, just that story. Of course, in a slightly different way, not that completely figured out. Then Khosla happened, Oye Lucky happened. Then the studio came to me and I didn't want to do something big budget because I knew that I would forever be trapped into that. So I wanted to do something completely which was opposite to Khosla and Oye Lucky. So then I said ki ye jo kahani thi usko beech wali kahani banate hain, wo jo beheading wali thi usko pehli wali bana lete hain, then fir aur kuch sochte hain. And then while writing it, the time, the relationship of the time came in, wo pehle nahi tha, while writing it came.
हाँ,
there's a connection between the two. वो सबको टाई कर रही है, सबको टाई कर रही है, और वो जिंदा है, जो मर गए हैं वो जिंदा है. वो तो again अपनी कहानी को टाई कर रही है। तो अपनी कहानी, अपनी जो सुपर स्टोरी है, उसका एक अपना क्लाइमैक्स है, विच मे नॉट बी द क्लाइमैक्स ऑफ देयर लाइव्स। सो आई थिंक व्हाट स्टोरीज लेट अस डू इज दैट दे लेट अस स्टेप इन टू ऑल्टरनेटिव टाइम जोन्स एंड ऑल्टरनेटिव यूनिवर्सेस। इन फैक्ट टू कम टू दिस थिंग, योर ओरिजिनल क्वेश्चन, विच इज अ गुड क्वेश्चन, देयर इज ओनली वन थिंग इन दिस होल यूनिवर्स विच लेट्स अस स्टेप आउट ऑफ आर बॉडी एंड ऑफ आर हेड, एंड दैट्स अ स्टोरी। देयर इज नो अदर वे दैट यू कैन स्टेप आउट ऑफ योर बॉडी और योर हेड। अभी वर्चुअल रियलिटी आएगी, देखते हैं क्या होता है, व्हेन एलएसडी 2, यू नो। सो बिकॉज वी ऑलवेज वॉन्टेड टू गेट आउट ऑफ दिस प्रिजन, राइट, दिस प्रिजन ऑफ आर बॉडी एंड दिस प्रिजन ऑफ आर हेड। ओनली अ स्टोरी कैन डू दैट टिल नाउ। you have to leave design school, go to a film school and start learning how to write script. It'll take about 2-3 years. You'll have to read a lot. You will not only have to read scripts, you'll have to read stories, you'll have to read novels, you'll have to read theater, you'll have to watch a lot of films and theater, and you have to understand what we've been discussing, that how to put it on the page. तो ये छोड़ना पड़ेगा। It doesn't matter. फिल्म स्कूल से अच्छे अच्छे आए हैं, विदाउट फिल्म स्कूल भी बहुत अच्छे अच्छे आए हैं। इट डिपेंड्स ऑन योर तबीयत। आई लर्नड दैट आई कांट लर्न इन एन इंस्टीट्यूशन। आई लर्नड दैट आई कैन लर्न बेस्ट वाइल वर्किंग। बट अमेजिंग पीपल हैव कम आउट ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट, राजकुमार राव FTI, सो बट नवाज, ही वॉज अ सिक्योरिटी गार्ड एट मंडी हाउस, बोथ वर्क। कुछ रूल नहीं है, देयर आर मेनी DOPs हू हैवंट गॉन टू, बट यस, ए DOP सिंस इट्स अ टेक्निकल क्राफ्ट एंड अ साइंटिफिक क्राफ्ट, 90% ऑफ देम टुडे, 95% ऑफ देम टुडे हैव टू गो थ्रू अ कोर्स, साइंटिफिक एंड टेक्निकल, एंड यू हैव टू डील विद लॉट्स ऑफ चेंजिंग टेक्निक्स एंड टेक्निकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ।
नवाज इज नॉट NSD?
नो, अल्टीमेटली ही गॉट इनटू रेपेटरी, ultimately got into repertory, ultimately he used to hang around those people, ultimately used to create.
If you could direct a sequel to any films that you have created from the past, which one would you take?
I'm writing Vyomkesh 2.
ye to LSD 2 bana
li, LSD 2 bana li, jiske paise milenge main sab bana lunga.
dusra baat, and what about the film that you have created, any Indian film,
any,
if you have to direct
जिसका फर्स्ट पार्ट मैंने नहीं किया, हाँ मतलब उसका फर्स्ट पार्ट मैंने नहीं बनाया,
इसके पैसे अच्छे मिल रहे हैं।
कैन यू सजेस्ट वन, क्या पता पैसे मिल जाए। अमर अकबर एंथनी 2, उसके पैसे नहीं मिलेंगे भाई, जान चुके हैं मेरे को, पहचान चुके हैं। अभी तक मैं ऐसे ऐसे जा रहा था, अभी मैं दागी आसामी हूँ। एजेंट विनोद मैंने देखी नहीं एक्चुअली, आई वुड नो। हाँ तुम्बाड़ नहीं, आई नो आनंद एंड हिज टीम वेरी वेल, तो मैं क्या करूँगा, वही करेंगे। नहीं, दैट इज सो अनुराग दैट इट वोंट बी फन इफ आई डू इट, बिकॉज वी आर वेरी डिफरेंट दैट वे, वी आर वेरी डिफरेंट, दैट्स वेरी अनुराग, नहीं हो अनुराग ही कर सकता है।
Anybody else? Abhi, we should.
I heard that you're finding producers for these new producers?
Huh? Sorry?
Are you finding more producers to buy from Netflix?
Yeah.
What if that doesn't work out?
What
is the process for that?
You keep sending it to various producers. They write कि हम इतने अच्छे director हैं, ये इतनी अच्छी film है, and then
that's maybe.
You do PPTs, you do pitches and all that, right. And, you know.
You've been at it.
Yeah.
Labs where you do pitches for your stories.
Yes.
So I've not experienced it. How does it work?
NFDC used to do something called ये दो Paul Gumbra का scooter and 11वीं के लड़के, ठीक है, ये दोनों पढ़ लो. And English में I'm very tempted to talk to them, tell them about Borges, but वो शायद
बोल दो.
हाँ, बोर्गेस पढ़ लो. बोर्गेस टू द डॉन क्विहोटे दैट सर्वेंटिस इज रिटन, बट द क्रिटिक इज प्रूविंग के हाउ इट्स अ कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट स्टोरी व्हाइल हैविंग एग्जैक्टली द सेम वर्ड्स. बोर्गेस की है डॉन क्विहोटे, वो अभी आ जाएगा. वो समरीज बोर्गेस इज राइटिंग एज अ क्रिटिक about a Don Quixote written by a certain other guy, and he's arguing as to why it's a completely different Don Quixote, though it's word for word the same as Cervantes' Don Quixote.
Pierre Menard.
That's also so. Ek cheez false nahi hai. Sari cheez, matlab, you know, layers and layers of what could have been and what not. So this is so that's that. Another English book, what else could I? M and the Big Home. Yes, I said that. M and the Big Home, Jerry Pinto, right?
Yeah.
It's about contemporary Bombay, so you'll get it quite right. And for the last book, M and the Big Home. Read anything by Rushdie, the thinnest book possible, so that it doesn't intimidate you. Huh?
Harun and the Sea of Stories.
Read anything by Rushdie. He's writing about India now. You can understand and all that. You may not like it. But I mean, try it. You may like it. Yeah? M and the Big Home, Harun and the Sea of the Studies, and Pierre Menard. Ah, it's a good range.
Films to watch is
Sab Pirate Bay mein milengi. Theek hai? Sare torrent karne padenge. Theek hai? ये तो तैयार है. मेमोरीज ऑफ मर्डर देखी हुई है? हाँ, सबने देखी हुई है. अरे वाह, तो जिन्होंने अच्छा तो ओके फाइन. मेमोरीज ऑफ मर्डर एंड लुई माल की एक फिल्म है, बहुत पुरानी फिल्म है. एक कोई कर लो ना उसका. नो, जाजी इन द मेट्रो इज नॉट लुई माल, इज इट लुई माल? या ओके, लुई माल का लुसियन लाकॉम्ब लुसियन LACOMBE LUCIEN लाकॉम्ब लुसियन, ये लुई माल की एक फिल्म है. देन मेमोरीज ऑफ मर्डर हो गया, ये हो गया, और क्या हो गया, रेजिंग बुल देख लो. दे आर देयर एंड it's like, yeah, I mean, I don't remember digging something out like that. It always keeps happening. Like right now, I'm writing a graphic novel. Okay. It'll probably finish in 3 years.
Okay. I mean, but you're writing something.
Yeah. Speak.
What are you reading currently?
Currently, I'm reading about 5 or 6 books. Inko matlab mera research wala chakkar hai. So I'm reading a book called The Horse, The Wheel, and check it. Abhi aa jayega. The Horse, The Wheel, and
The Language.
It's about Indo-European languages. And I'm reading a series of detective stories. By very interesting stories. You will love them. Read this detective story called, novel called My Friend Maigret by a writer called Georges Simenon. My Friend Maigret, M-A-I-G-R-E-T, My Friend Maigret. This is what I'm reading. I'm reading other Maigret stories, but My Friend Maigret is very interesting. And I'm reading 3-4 other books.
Criticism and feedback.
I don't have to balance it because, you know, because of whatever creativity I exercise, film ban jati hai. And there is nothing but feedback and criticism that comes my way. So I have to shut up and take it. Because if I start fighting it, then people say, hey, you're closed and all that. Also, I want to hear. So, yeah, I would like to be universally praised. To be universally praised. But wo hota nahi. It never happens. So you have to take it. You have to take it and shut up.
So future was the main reason for the piece, not really.
My guess. We heard it on the grapevine that it's from there. It could be anything. It could be the whole thing. It could be just as simple as five people in LA sitting together and looking at blah 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 blah. We've got this much of shell space. Ye thoda problematic hai. It's nothing against the film. It's worse than that. It's a. So. Hopefully.
Sir, so I take this. Thank you so much. For
it's quite a chat, actually. I've really enjoyed it. Thank you.